at Lee Valley on a Saturday watching UCL Women's Ones play KCL Kings Women's Ones. I'm Nandini, I'm commentating with Sterling from Kings. Over to you, Sterling.
Hello there, my name is Robert William Sterling. Like Nadine just introduced us, we are currently watching a splendid sunset.
Very splendid.
Over the Lee Valley grounds.
Mm.
The grounds have been watered quite heavily, you'll see plenty of splash later.
Mm.
So what can you tell me, Nadine, about your team?
Well, they're lovely. Lovely, lovely people. But more important than being lovely people, they're fantastic players. And even more fantastic than their play is their chat. So do come to the vault. Is that where the after party is?
Absolutely. I do believe.
Yeah. Come along to the after party if you're not, unfortunately, here at the game. If you could not make it to the game, I'm sure you're live streaming and listening to our dulcet tones. Dulcet? Dulcet. Dulcet. With a sir, in fact. Are you excited for the after party?
Oh, absolutely. But yeah. I'll be more excited about a game that's about to unveil before us.
Of course. Yeah. It's all about the sport.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
No drinking involved. Not what you're on about.
No. This is a sober affair.
So, here we've got the Kings team. Should be coming out very soon.
Mm.
Between them, they've got 22 international caps. Quite a very experienced team.
Wow.
I know.
22 international caps.
Captains? No, that means how many games they've played internationally between them.
Oh, thanks.
So between ex-England players, Wales, as well as Ulster, they've got quite a lot of experience between them. And there we go, the teams are coming out now.
Here we go. There they are. Wowee. Look at that grandeur. Wow. There we go. There is that noise. There is that support. Can you hear that? Walking with their heads up.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. We've got our goalie nipples right there. Number one. Excellent.
Cool. I've got to go into the tunnel.
Sure, yeah, take it away. There they are, wow. Power. I think you can tell from the...
On the right hand side, we've got Honey Mears. Lisa Peters, Lola Smith, Hannah Woods, Sarah Semple, Kat Langley, Amy Fudge, Amy Illiston, Chrissy Jowett, Gracie Andrew, and Indy Callan playing. On the bench, Lily Nash, Addy Brennan, Lucy Spence, Lottie McGurson, and Felix Fern. Honourable mention to Tony Telford, who couldn't make it due to COVID. Now on to the UC side.
Number 9, Juju, our president. Hello, thank you very much. Number 11, Eve, biochemical engineering was a fact about herself. Excellent. 12, Katie, who's second year law student. Uh-oh, don't make any legal mistakes there. 13, Melissa, also a law student. Third year, though, year ahead. Number 14, Zara, she's from Yorkshire. 15, Josie. And 16, Amelia. That is our squad for UCL. Let's take it away.
Well done, great freshman.
And here we go. I think we're... Who's got the toss? Did you see who's got the first pushback? I think it's our captain, Kathy, who's got the first pushback. This is very exciting.
She's looking rather anxious, I must say. Look at that, staring down the ball.
Yeah. Attitude. There is attitude and power on the pitch today at Lee Valley. It's very exciting to be here, to witness it in person, don't you think?
Oh, absolutely. I think everyone in the crowd is currently going absolutely wild.
Yeah.
KCL is singing their little chant.
There we go, and we're away. And we're away. Oh.
Oh, I'm hearing profanity from the UC side already.
So Kings have got the ball though. There we go. They've got possession, passing it back through the defence. Lovely crossover, if I may say so. I know I should be supporting UC, but they've got the ball. This is the thing. They take the ball every time. There we go. Little pass over. Oh,
beautiful defence there.
Oh.
And
there
again,
we go.
What a sexy slap. Out, straight out.
In, we're in. Oh, brilliant. I think that's a short corner, if I'm not mistaken. Two lovely UCL. Wonderful. Already in with such a lovely advantage.
Quite an aggressive start then from UC. We'll see if they can keep that up.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see if the stamina can keep up that pace.
Mm-hmm. What have we got going on? I'm afraid both Sterling and I are rather visually impaired, so it's tricky for us to see the numbers, but I think that's... Nope, can't see. Let's have a look. That's number four.
We've got a player about to hit.
That's Molly Woodburn injecting. Oh, there's a camera. Brilliant. Oh, have a look. And we're out. Got the ball. Taking it in. Oh, lovely dodge there. We're taking it for a goal. Oh, bit of defence. Bit of defence from KCL. Okay. They've taken it out. Fine, fine. Happens.
Lovely dribbling on the side.
There's a lovely bit of defence from number 16. Amelia. Getting in there with that medical aggression, I do believe.
Well done, Sarah. Lots of control. Sarah and 13.
That's good. That was a nice bit
good
of defensive play from UC and Kings. To
beautiful
their,
slap.
To their
what accuracy.
Cheeky foot. It's okay. It's fine. We're putting the press on. That's okay.
Not too much of a setback for UC, I imagine.
More for Kings.
However, the possession's looking good on our side.
There we go. Nice bit of possession.
Beautiful
from Kings.
Handling.
Crossing over. Lovely pitch play. And the captain is there surveying the entire play.
Sarah passing into the centre.
Kings taking it up. UC defence. Oh, delightful. Absolutely delightful. That is our goalkeeper, who is not, in fact, a second year, but is a fresher. This is her first varsity, would you believe?
It's a beautiful pass from Kat. Kat is one of our international players who have played for Wales.
Lovely bit of defence there from UCL. We're taking back up to midfield. Is someone there to receive it? Yes, there is someone there, and it is only our captain. Oh,
beautiful pass straight into our hands. We do love it when you play into our hands.
Oh, well.
This is our renowned dribbling skills.
And that's our renowned defensive skills, I do believe.
Chrissy is in fact known for her dribbling skills. Very much so. She played England in the past and is from a very sporty family.
But there we
two
go.
Generations
is...
of in the Olympics. As well as her grandfather's been three times at the Olympics themselves.
Really?
Indeed.
Wow.
Yes. Though I do reckon her sister's better at playing hockey than she is.
Excellent goal saving there from
almost there, Kings.
Becca.
Keep going at it. We'll get through them eventually.
There it is. There it is. Lovely, lovely bit of work. That's Zara Elvidge on the ball.
Good pass.
That was a nice bit of skill work.
Cat driven pass, everyone passing to Amy.
Where are we going? We're going towards the midfield. Passing it across, lovely. Zara's there on the right, taking it forward. Lovely bit of control there. And we are crossing it in, excellent. Taken up by KCL, fine.
Sadly, I think your players are just as visually impaired as ours are, so.
unlucky lost the ball there, but.
Lovely tag.
Lovely. Lovely defensive
sadly,
play.
Sadly, just a little bit overly aggressive from India.
There we go. Lovely crossing. That's Molly Woodburn on the ball. Unlucky.
Beautiful
but
defense.
Zara Elvidge has picked it up. And she's staying on it, she's staying on it, despite considerable attack from Kings. lucky. There's a bit of pressure there.
It seems to me like the Kings players are absolutely every old time. It's good to see.
Sterling, if I'm not mistaken, it looks like Kings and UCL are quite matched in play today.
Ooh,
it's head, no, it's head against
considering
head.
Considering the fact we've just scored.
Oh, goodness. Uh-oh. Not really, though, because I think she shot from outside the Ooh. Goal. So, uh-oh.
Interesting call.
It's the visual impairment playing up again there. There's a camera right here if you want to just have a closer look.
Hitting our balls at the goal. And, one will get through. Don't fret not, Nini. Fret not.
There we go. This is a short corner now to Kings. This is a defensive short corner for UCL. We have quite a few chants going on from both crowds. Lovely bit of witty repartee from both ends. Storm coming.
So Kings are ready.
There we go.
This could be a very big opening play.
There we go, getting into position.
Huge lunge. There we go.
Goodness, that was very tense. And that is another short corner to Kings.
Are we going to be witness to more lunging?
The ultimate question of the entire Varsity tournament, in
Absolutely.
Fact.
Absolutely. There we go. That's a big old lunge.
That was quite a large lunge.
Very big one.
Deep stretch.
That's how you know Kings, there's a lot of gym.
Oh, oh, oh,
look at that.
Oh,
beautiful
dear
tumbling through the air.
That was straight out. We're watching the replay. Caught it outside of the D, straight in, and lovely flick. I must say,
thanks.
I think Becca, our goalie, or any goalie for that matter, would struggle to defend that. It was a really excellent goal from Kings. But not to worry, because you see, we are, you know what, we hope and we dream and we put those dreams into action as we are right now, taking the ball up on the left wing and getting things going yet again. Oh, little tackle there from Kings, not to worry, because I do believe, yep, as I believe, and now we're seeing in practice, the ball is back on UC's side.
We love to see UC getting nice and aggressive, straight back into it, trying to make up for, sadly, what was not the best opening 5 minutes. I hear plenty of low intelligence profanity coming
from the
UC side.
None from
UC
the commentator
side.
Booth, though.
Absolutely no. We don't do explicit.
No, we're better than that.
Not in our repertoire.
There we go. Little sideline moment there on the left. We're taking it up, and I think we are taking it to the crossing it over the pitch. Lovely cross there. Where Zara taking it into the. Oh dear. That was straight into the King's stick, unfortunately.
Well,
but it's okay because, yep, defended by
middle,
our own UC. I
where
think that
three
is
players are
Iona taking it forward.
Well done, Amy. A lot of power behind that, suddenly strength in.
That was our president right there, taking the ball out of the D, yeah. Proud, proud moment.
Oh yeah, one for the history books, I'm sure.
Oh. That's our future captain, I think, of the ones taking, oh, lovely little spin around. What's happened?
Unlucky, Amy. Big kick.
There's big lunges and big kicks and everything's off.
Sometimes we do forget ourselves and start playing football on a pitch, clearly.
Only for the goalie.
Oh, yes.
Only for the goalie.
Did you manage to get him from the football team?
Sorry?
Did you manage to get a keeper from the football team?
Yeah, she's very talented. Multi-talented, in fact.
Multi-talented.
She's, I think, on a Sunday you can see her doing high jump.
Oh, really? Wow.
Actually, no. There's no athletics in the Varsity, I don't think. Sorry. That was a lie.
I thought you meant just generally on a Sunday evening.
Yeah,
going into some high jumps.
Oh dear. It's okay. That was a little comforting.
That was a beautiful demonstration of the standard skill set of UCL.
That was a comforting tap on the shoulder from our captain and a breeze right over that from Sterling. No need for it. It's all a bit of friendly love. It's okay. There we go. We're back in the attacking D. Take it forward.
Very
I do believe that is a short
player.
Corner awarded to UC.
The sidelines are now very loud. Yeah, yes, absolutely
very
love
exciting.
To hear it.
Very
I can almost
exciting.
Hear myself.
You can't?
Almost can't. That could be something to do with also my degrading ear.
It's the eyesight and the hearing. Together makes the perfect commentator.
And since I've started uni, my liver too.
Since you started rugby, particularly, in fact. Here we go, another deep lunge. There we go, it's out. Taken in by the captain and straight in. Unlucky
beautiful
defended,
defense.
But stops there. Taking it forward once again. Crossed into the middle, top D. Taking it forward, taking it forward. Lovely bit of skill there. And we are in with the first goal for UCL, taking it 1-1. Sterling just went like, well done as well. I think he is rather impressed. Are you impressed, Sterling? Yes.
What I'm going to say is I'm going to allow you to do the honours to put that on the tannoy.
Wait, what did you say?
Do the honours, put on the tannoy.
Oh, go on then. Wait, hold my mic.
Very well done there.
That was the highlight of my university career. Very fun.
Square one. Sadly, we've just given up our clean sheet. No worries. The Varsity is very much still a winnable affair. Especially with plays like that from UC.
You go, captain taking the ball on the dotted line. Intercepted, picked up.
King's running straight back up into the field, ready to receive the ball.
There we go, hit out for Kings, but there's quite a strong
big slab
defense.
For
defence.
Wonderfully sexy. Oh,
nice, nice, lovely defence from our president, Julia. Woo! Strong play from Ella McCarthy, next year's ones captain. She's there, she's picked it up. Oh,
there's some real wheels
she's picked
on
it up, but it's gone to Kings.
But all she's done is played it straight into Sarah's hands. Down the line to Indy. Indy dribbling it past the opposition. Down the middle.
Oh, it was a beautiful stick tackle, I think, from Kings, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, but the ball has gone to Kings, so perhaps I was mistaken. There we go.
Cap, taking in.
It's gone straight into the D. And defended from UCL. It's out. Goodness, this is a very tense moment. But Zara Elvidge has taken it away. She's zooming down the pitch. Unlucky, it's gone off the pitch and it is a King's ball. No, it's a UCL ball. Goodness, how exciting is this game?
Indeed.
You think it's one thing and it's quite the other. Lovely, lovely pass across.
Nice little step over the hockey sticks in front of her. Unlucky cat.
Eve Hartley on the ball. We are in the corner, I'm afraid. Corner's a scary spot to be in.
Also, not only are you in a physical corner, but also a metaphorical one.
I meant the literal corner on the pitch. Do you feel in a metaphorical corner?
I feel like
a small box,
UC, maybe.
No, I think UCL are doing just fine. There we go. Nice bit of defence from UCL there. Strong, very strong.
Also, Sarah, nice and composed. Looking for place, pass it back towards her defence.
Crossed over. We're going up to the right. Oh, straight in down the mid, in fact.
In the middle field by herself.
Nice touch there from Eve Hartley. And we are back with UCL in possession. Lovely, lovely movement. Unfortunately picked up by Kings yet again.
I would like to give a shout out to Elisa, who's actually paid her subs now. Well done. It's taking some nagging. It's been done.
UCL possession and crossed over. Look at that.
Now, while we watch the game, what do you make of the fact that last time we played UC, we beat them 3-2?
I think the past is the past, Sterling. You can't ruminate over it. Okay. You'll get yourself into all kinds of trouble if you do that, all kinds of psychological messes and knots and such. Spend too much time on the past and you forget about the present, okay?
That's
and look where we
quotes.
Are in the present. I think we are in UCL possession in the present.
Oh, I'll tell you where you are in the present. Currently in the Bucks League, you are behind Kings as well.
But the Bucks League is not what we're playing in. I do believe it's Varsity that we're playing in. Bucks League
Indeed,
is a...
We are,
in
we're
fact,
very similar players.
Bucks League is a whole other league, I do believe, you know?
We're very similar players, like I said.
Touché. Sorry, I'm just stretching.
Doing some
just doing a
hip rearrangements.
Yeah.
Wonderful pass there. Nice and collected up the pitch.
Picked up by Ella McCarthy, but the ball is going to Kings.
Beautiful cross the pitch. Nice and accurate pass there. Sarah stops him.
Lovely pick up there from Eve Hartley. Oh, beautiful skill. Lovely.
Ends up on the floor.
That is a ball to UC. That is a ball to UC, and that is very exciting.
That is Lily Nash coming on, the first team captain from last year. She has gone completely and utterly MIA since winning Varsity last year.
Oh, why?
Very good question.
No one knows. She puts the mystery in MIA, in fact.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
That is Indy back on.
There's a King's ball. They're taking it into the middle. But there is a strong slew of UCL players. Oh, back to Kings, though. Nice bit of pressure there. Unlucky jab from number 8. There we go.
Well, I'm sorry, your passing is better than your faked hand. Wonderful.
Ooh, ouch. Ooh, goodness.
Oh, right. Her faked hand is her personality.
Oh, right. Fine. Gentle dig.
I mean, she's the kind of person that went out on a night out, managed to smash her front two teeth in.
Legend.
On the tube, and then proceeded to carry on going out.
Very,
that is
very
the kind
good.
Of person we're talking about, currently defending our side. So we can vouch that even if we do have some broken teeth today, she'll carry on playing.
That's very impressive. That is very impressive.
That is Addy coming on. Well done, Addy.
Lovely, beautiful pass, so beautiful in fact that it was unstoppable. Very strong. Ella McCarthy.
It's good to see Chrissy coming back on. She's renowned for subbing herself off at every and absolute opportunity, so her going back on is an absolute miracle.
Wow, it is a day of miracles.
It is truly, truly damn.
That goal at the start from Kings actually was a miracle. I don't know how they...
That's funny. I was just about to say that about the UC goal.
Really?
Like a day full of miracles indeed.
I think the biggest miracle, though, is the sunset that we have going ahead of us, which
God.
Is still going on. Would you look
Absolutely
at that?
Absolutely wonderful.
Wow.
Almost, but not quite, distracts me from the game.
Here we go. Kings have the ball again in the middle. And Zara Elvidge on that ball again.
Chrissy,
the stick is flying. The stick is flying. We're playing a different game. No, unfortunately, Zara Elvidge is a sprinter, but she could not sprint to save that ball. It's gone back to Kings. And who is that Kings player? Sarah. Sarah, is that the fake tan lady?
I.
Who is the fake tan lady?
Sarah.
13.
Yeah, 13.
Oh, lovely. Lucky number that, isn't it?
Rather unfortunate.
Yeah. And we're taking it forward from UCL. Nice bit of defence from Kings.
Wonderful doing from Kat. The last we've seen plenty of from Kings' side today, sadly.
Got a bit excited there, the Kings did,
fruition.
I think. They did get a bit excited. They took it forward. But you know what? Sometimes it's about patience.
Well, yes, we're a very excitable team. We love playing hockey. We love the game.
Do you love to play hockey?
I
with your
love
much hockey playing hockey experience. Yeah. Women's hockey or men's or both? Mixed?
I'm the mixed manager,
yeah.
So.
Yeah. Back to Kings.
Yes, I am currently in the mixed manager position for KCL hockey. Totally and utterly not a fictitious position.
As an avid rugby player, Sterling is very qualified to be mixed games manager. Is that what you said? Yeah. And UCL taking it across the pitch. Lovely transfer over to their left. Into the middle again. Lovely. That was a nice carrying forward. Unlucky interception from Kings. But taking it back to UCL and another interception is on the hands. It's excitable once again.
We've been seeing a lot of good dribbling in the middle. Sadly, Lily wasn't able to pass that up properly, sadly.
This is our UCL president, women's president on the ball. Lovely transfer. Lovely pickup as well. Nearly lost it there, but we've still got our stick on the ball and our eyes on the ball. Eyes on the play. Still got it. We have still got it. That's excellent, isn't it? Look at that.
You've still got it. The one thing you didn't have, though, in the last two mixed games against us is a keeper. In the last two games against Kings, you've actually not brought a keeper, which was absolutely incredible to see.
Sterling, as an avid hockey player myself, I can vouch for the fact that you don't actually need a keeper sometimes to win.
Sadly, before I was going to play balls and do the loss. Play a high one like that.
Here we go.
Now, it's good to see you've actually brought a keeper along this time, though.
Yes.
I reckon it is still a football player that's been bribed to come and stand in a goal.
Do you know what? Whatever does the trick, though.
Even that on a local post woman.
I disagree, but okay. Moving on. Swiftly. Is that that's a short corner? That's a defensive short corner for UCL. And yeah, consequently an attacking one for Kings. That's how it works in defence and attack. What do you think it's gonna be? Another goal or another save from UCL?
Well, we've already proved our ability to do short corners.
I think it's all in the lunge. This lunge.
Efficiency. And yes, back to the lunge.
Back to the lunge.
Love to see it.
Nice bit of booing from UCL. Good team spirit.
Good.
And it was in the air, but not in the goal. And it's off the pitch again.
She's known for her reverse slaps. Something she does a lot of in games.
Sarah?
The same way that Chrissy loves to dribble up and down the ball. With the stick, not with her mouth.
Oh dear. Oh dear. Goodness. There we go.
What
that was an excellent stop from Kings player there. But nice pick up from our very own Molly Woodburn on UCL. There we go. She's taking the ball forward. Lovely, lovely slap across the pitch. Taking it forward and a nice bit of dribbling. Unlucky pickup there from Kings. There we go, Zara Elvidge. Absolutely zooming back up.
3-on-1, still maintaining the ball.
It's a Kings ball, I do believe.
It is indeed. Taken from KSL, across the pitch to Amy. Beautiful dribbling up the sideline from our right wing.
Nice little save there from our very own Becca. And that is a UCL hit out.
What do you make of the game so far, Nani?
It's just very exciting. It's just a real privilege to be here. The fact that we get to commentate on top of it is just, you know, cherry on the cake. But just to witness such excellent play, I mean, both from Kings and UCL, you know. It
a
is truly
historic event in the making.
Yeah, it is truly a match between titans. Lovely pickup there from Eve, demonstrating that titanic behaviour.
Oh.
And there we go, back to Zara Elvidge, who was on the ball quite a fair bit this game. Lovely, lovely bit of defence there. Lovely bit of pressure from Eve Hartley. Very good, forcing the ball around. Dynamic play from our very own Prez. There we go. Takes it forward but gets stopped. But it's back to UCL.
The possession is going back and forth a little bit, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, it is. Asics sign of a healthy game. Healthy game,
healthy
I think.
Game,
yeah.
There we go.
Who's that swapping?
In number 9, we've got Felice coming on.
Who do you think is the louder chant?
Whoa, so far I've heard a lot more KCL. They're really, really on their songs.
Unfortunately, I think I have to admit that's true. They're quite loud.
I think they're being led by a present seamer, by the looks of it, who currently can't be on a pitch for fear of making the game unfair.
Oh, how so?
Oh, she's just incredibly good. And
absolutely
not in the third team.
Right. Excellent. Very good. Very good. Kings have possession there, taking out the left. It's number 13, the fake tan lady, yes?
Is that her official moniker now? Beautiful reverse hit.
Well, I don't know. I think it's, you know, more than the fake tan. I think she has another goal to celebrate, because that is now 2-1 to Kings. So KI fully believe in UCL's power to bring it back, as they have proved they can do from earlier. Nice little pass over to Kings. But I think that is our very own Tabby Evans. Defending harshly, but defending nonetheless.
Give a slap to Kat. Down the line. It's Felice. To Amy in right wing. Beautiful dribbling skills.
Beautiful, but they have led the ball off the pitch.
Sadly, not come to fruition the way she might have hoped it would have.
It's okay. Lovely transfer across the pitch. The pitch? Goodness.
I promise she has not been drinking. In here the whole time.
I promise.
Who's coming on here? Number 8.
We're number 8. That's Ellie.
Good to see Ellie back on the pitch. Nice little feint.
Good cheeky pass.
Unlucky Sarah did not.
But perhaps a bit too much pressure. Zara Elvidge on the ball again. Zara Elvidge has seen a fair bit of play this match, wouldn't you agree?
Oof.
Lovely spin-off from Ella McCarthy, unfortunately blocked by King's defence. But it is a UCL ball, and there we go. Balance is restored.
Kings may be winning, but we are not allowed to lay on our laurels, sadly. Cruising will not win us this match.
Mm.
It's been made very obvious. We see the UC subs in a huddle. On the sidelines.
They are huddling. They are doing a huddle, taking a huddle, huddling.
Presumably because the chill has settled a little bit. It's very warm earlier. It's not as warm now.
Are you cold?
I may not be, but the players very much are when they're standing around. You can see the Kings players warming up their shoulders, ready to come on in a minute.
Unlucky, that was nearly a goal for UCL. But the King's defence, I think, in this case, got the better of them. And here we go, the UCL chants are back on their business, I do believe. And there we go. Who's that King's player, Sterling, taking it away? Crossing it very, very beautifully. And
I wish I wasn't so visually impaired.
were trying to take it up the pitch, but UCL are just beautifully getting in the way, as they absolutely should, because you know what? That's how you defend.
What a wonderful receive from Chrissy, dribbling into the D.
Oh, goodness. I do believe that's
Chrissy
a short corner.
Chrissy was not happy with that decision.
Nope, it's a hit out. Lovely hit out. Taking it away. Taking it up the pitch. Zooming. Lost the ball. But nice bit of possession there from Iona Lindsay, I do believe. And into... I can't see who that is. Number six? Is that number six? That's Ella McCarthy. Up the pitch. Lovely touches there. And it is UCL's captain taking it forward. We have a free... Oh, dear.
It was brought up very, very, very elegantly.
Very unfortunate.
Didn't seem to find back of the net.
The goalie, I don't know if we can see the replay, but the goalie was out of the goal. Our captain had a free shot, but she was in a very awkward position from where it is quite
I think Hanny in goal was currently doing really quite well. As on letting one goal, which is better than most of her debuts.
There we go, it's a long corner taken by Ella McCarthy. Taking it right into that corner and very nicely sneaking into the D. Unsuccessfully. Taking it up there, Kings. What player is that? Who have we got there, Sterling? On the right-hand far side. And into the
it
middle now.
Nice to me.
But that is, again, Zara Elvidge. A true player. True queen. Brilliant. Look at that.
Movement.
Lovely lift up.
There we go. Between Kat, Chris and Sarah, well done. Now Kat here, this is her second game of the day. She was playing earlier today for St Albans.
Wow.
Can
very
you
impressive.
Imagine?
Very impressive, Kat.
Absolutely tired. That's Sarah coming off, and so is Amy.
Nice touch there from Kings.
Indy. No, wrong.
Taken again
Amy
by
coming
UCL.
On.
Taking it back. And straight into the D. Wow. Look at that. Goalie hits it out and chased by Tabby Evans, who keeps it in play. Lovely pass back. Picked up from Kings. Oh no. Injury prone Zara Elvidge is down. But the play continues. Kings have the ball. UCL have the ball. Yes. Middle play. Here we go. Passing to the right, lovely little tip there. Zara Elvidge back on her feet, trying to find a way in, and we have our way in. Stopped by Kings, however.
It would appear that dive was not acknowledged, sadly, by the
I know,
umpire.
Shame. I thought it was rather heroic.
There was some flair to it, I must say.
Yeah, so, bit of drama, bit of tragedy.
We do like a little bit of drama.
She is off the pitch now, though.
So in a previous game against UCL, Kat, Elisa and Sarah scored. And Sarah scored with reverse hits and that's what she did just now. Very well done.
Oh, a rather unsuccessful hit there from number six, Kings. Taking it away, Ella McCarthy, who's apparently dyed her hair purple, but I don't know, would you say that's purple? It looks rather pink.
It looks something between baby pink and kind of lilac.
Very specific on the colours there. Are you sure it's not history of art that you're studying?
I'm somewhat of an artiste.
So artiste, yeah.
Self-proclaimed.
Lovely skill work, but goodness, is that a little physical throwdown we've got going on?
I can't tell if that was a celebration, a hug, or
a friendly hug, or I'll talk to you later, I'll have a word with you, yeah, something like that, yeah.
See, I reckon it was one of those embraces where they whisper into each other's ears.
Yeah.
We're going to see you off the pitch later.
UCL long corner, taken by Iona Lindsay. Pass to her left, straight in.
Big hit.
Oh,
wonderful stuff from Hanny.
By the goalie. But we're still in.
And again, that woman knows no bounds when it comes to stopping balls. Absolutely wonderful. This is turning up to be a pretty good game.
And that is half time, I do believe.
We're living up to our Wednesday's game, which was 9-3. We're looking good.
What do we think of the match so far, Sterling? How's it looking?
Possession is back and forth.
Yeah.
There's a lot of fighting over the ball.
Yeah.
A lot of fight.
Kings are very excited. It is evident. They're very excited. They have pom-poms in fact.
Yes, we've actually brought our own
cheerleaders. Yes. What in the world? I'm sorry. I thought we were in England, not America. But how exciting regardless. There are...
It's a shame we can't see UCL Lightning on the opposing side. Oh, that's your cheerleaders.
Oh, right, yeah. Yeah, they've got their own Varsity, so they're busy.
They were currently away at League, I believe, doing Legacy competition, where they scored 83 points. I see Hanny coming off the pitch there. Very proud. Well done, Hanny.
That's a thumbs up from Sterling, for those who missed it. An iconic thumbs up.
An iconic thumbs up. It's going to be historic. There is currently a huddle going on.
the damn huddles.
In the goal. I can't tell if they're taking a picture or trying to get warm. Perhaps they're discussing tactics.
I think it's the tactics, do you know, because the match isn't over. And we're only one goal down, actually, if you think about it. And if you look at the score sheet.
Anything can change.
We are just going to take a quick break now.
We're UCL Women's Hockey. Molly, what the fuck?
What did you do?
Alright, 3, 2, 1.
We're UCL Women's Hockey.
What's your earliest memory of hockey?
So I started playing hockey when I was... No, can you cut this though? I don't want obviously this to be...
Cut.
I'd say my earliest memory of hockey was probably when I was about 9 or 10 years old. I really wanted the hockey kit, but my mum said that I had to stick with hockey for at least a year before I could get the kit.
I came from like abroad and then completely being introduced to hockey at the age of like 8, I think.
I started playing hockey when I lived in Amsterdam for a bit when I was younger. Okay.
With the questions yourselves.
Yeah, we did when she was
that one. Not the. There's one I spotted later on that I don't recognize.
Alright, what's the best memory you've had at UCL?
The best memory I think has been like the big events such as Varsity. So, kind of those big events where everyone is involved and they kind of all get to come and have fun and enjoy the event.
There's an event called Mandy Walker. It's a charity event in the summer. Everybody gets to play and then afterwards there's barbecue and socialising. And the warmth and
with Ackies as well.
With Ackies, yeah, with old club members, which is really fun.
The social events at the start of the year as a hockey fresher was like sort of made my year.
What is being a part of Varsity
squad? Being part of the Varsity squad is a sense of pride. I know that the rest of the club is very much so behind you and they're just as much into it as the team playing.
Yeah, I would say there's something like really special about playing on the Olympic pitch, having, you know, the crowd behind you, as Kathy says, and the atmosphere is just amazing.
Nice. What have you done to prepare for Varsity?
We've got quite a vigorous strength and conditioning scheme going on at the moment. And the other thing that we're probably doing is we're playing the men's club quite a lot, which has been really good practice because they play a very different game to us.
I haven't started yet, but probably quite a lot of sleep.
Team bonding.
You're wrong. So kind of like the inter-year sort of socialising is really important, I think.
What's the best part about being captain?
Oh, good question. Maybe just being able to keep the team together, just to be able to sort of be a point of contact for all year groups and all players.
What will you do when you win?
Big celebration. It's going to be huge. Probably go back to the changing room. Bubbly? Is that allowed? Can I say that? I think especially in third year, it's a great feeling, hopefully, when we win.
And ladies and gentlemen, currently joining us in the live stream, welcome back to UCL Hockey versus KCL Hockey Varsity.
Yep. UCL looking refreshed and reinvigorated.
Starting us off, it's going to be Chrissy, number 6. Currently on the centre line. Beautiful pass to Kat. And out towards left wing.
That is lovely from UCL. Taking it forward. Intercepted by Kings, however.
Over to Amy. Over to number 15.
Lovely bit of defence there from Molly Woodburn. Unfortunately, it is a King's ball. Passing straight across. Lovely touch from Ella McCarthy. It's a rogue cheerleader there.
I don't even think that's a cheerleader.
Unlucky.
KCL currently going absolutely wild on the megaphone.
Very tuneful singing, yes.
Oh yes, definitely not overly high pitched.
That is going to go.
And shoot, older godless scum.
Over to
that is,
the left.
Standard chat in UCL. Yep.
Crossing it.
Gorgeous
lovely
slap.
Lovely pick up there.
Almost intercepted.
But not Kings quite. Player. Into the middle.
To Kat. Kat is currently being absolutely
nice touch.
Centered
nice
upon
touch
by three players. That's what it takes to stop our Kat. Lola taking out to the side. It lays up here, these. Beautiful pass to Amy. Amy, as per usual, running up the side.
Nice bit of pressure there from
lovely
Amy
pass.
Lindsay.
Over to Gracie. Gracie, calm and collected as always, slaps the ball across the pitch. Sadly, no one on the receiving end.
Lovely bit of pressure from UCL, forcing the ball off the pitch. And there we go again. Taking it forward, taking it away. Stopped by Kings.
Passed it straight into our hands. Or sticks, shall I say. Sadly, we're not allowed to use our hands in hockey.
In hockey, no. They'd get hurt.
Oh, very hurt. Batters. Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Many broken fingers.
Yeah.
Like the first team player, Dan, who had one of his fingers bent almost 90 degrees. Wonderful.
Mm.
Really? The x-rays are beautiful.
Art.
Oh, yes. For the contemporary
art.
Yeah.
Getting some lovely coaching advice from the stalls there. And it is a King's ball. Long corner for them.
Over from Kat to Amy in the right wing. Amy, beautiful.
Lovely. A beautiful pickup. You're right. Yes. That is our president taking it out. Picked up by the Kings player.
Eliza,
yes.
Gracie, number 12, right on it.
Lovely crossover.
Not quite fast enough.
To the very well-renowned Zara Elvidge. I think we have a megaphone over this end as well now. Some lovely expletives coming from left-hand side there. Very good. Another fall.
Or a dive, shall I say. As it was not acknowledged by our umpire. And
reverse
a wonderful
hit.
Reverse
stop.
Slap. Crikey.
That is a hit out for
sadly,
UCL.
A little bit on the high side.
A little bit. And also outside of the D, therefore. not a goal.
There could be a better times to do such a verdict. But I'll give you 10 out of 10 for fashion and flair.
Me, in particular, thank you.
Oh, wow, well, I was talking about the reverse,
not
but
the players,
you know what? The current face paint you've got on is, yeah, is quite something.
It is quite something, thank you.
Yeah. Fashioning a beard in
yeah,
a
RDJ.
Blue paint.
RDJ, yeah. It's a very specific tile. Very 2009.
That's all right. I'm currently fashioning a tie.
It's a tie of the King's Women's Ones team players. Very good. Well done,
and
Sterling.
That is not even a joke.
That is not. No, no one is joking here. It is completely serious. I'm looking at it, and it's just women's faces. If he wasn't at this event, it would be very, very perverted, would it not?
Yes. Can you imagine seeing that in the street? That would be rather
yes,
something.
We are looking at a defensive short corner for UCL and an attacking one for Kings.
There's been quite
thinking?
A few of those
yeah.
this game, hasn't there?
They have just short corners in general. Quite a game changer, really. There we go. Look at that lunge, deep.
It's very good because our team has clearly been practicing our short
Easy
corners.
Easy pass out, sticking in. But the defense
calm and collected, straight into the back of the net.
Not strong enough because the Kings players have indeed scored another goal. Take it to the tannoy. I know you want to. Oh dear.
Well done to Lola.
The energy on the pitch has changed. There is now an aggression from
That's
UCL.
Gracie coming off. And in number 9, we've got Felice coming back on. Well done to Gracie. Calm and collected as always. That is kind of a defining trait for Gracie, it seems.
Molly Woodburn taking it forward. Lovely pass, lovely touch. Unfortunately, no possession. There is a sense of, there is a frantic energy. I
get that. Everyone's trying to get to the goal as
and
far as possible.
It.
Get to the back of that net.
It. UCL are frantic to score. Kings are frantic to defend. Or perhaps they're just responding to UCL's frantic energy. We don't know.
It's absolute ADHD pornography.
Yeah, not the terms I'd use. I was going to say it's exhilarating, but Sterling, well, what can I say? He does physics. He's not a man of words necessarily. He's just a man
I've got a plethora of words. I've got all the
yeah,
words.
Yeah, he'll say plethora too many times for his own good. Which will leave you questioning whether, in fact, he knows what plethora means. What do you think it means?
A myriad.
There we go. I am looking at the camera organiser and we are both confused. Oh, goodness. Yep, that's UCL.
I've not heard any Polytechnic speech tonight, which I'm rather disappointed about.
Would you like to hear it? Would you like to be reminded
of it? Oh, please,
if
you've got some.
I can't. Oh, well, that is an aerial. Woo. That is an aerial if I've ever seen one, and it's stopped by Kings. You know, it only takes one aerial to change an entire game. It just changes the energy and the excitement. But unfortunately, Kings are in UCL's...
For a tough spot, by the looks of it. 3 people on 1 player.
Always the
a
way.
Hard one to get out. Wow. Yes.
There we go. It's happening. Too many things are happening at once.
Very much impressive play so far. Love to see Amy coming out of right wing to pick up that ball.
But it is a UCL hit
out.
It's
Chrissy.
That's a 16. Here we go. And that's Melissa Manley on the ball, but it's gone straight to Kings, unfortunately.
Lovely receive.
And another 16 to UCL. Taking it straight up.
Lovely interception. Change of possession once again.
Kings getting lively.
In Philly.
In the audience.
9.
Oh, goodness, oof. That was a bit scary. And surely that is a UCL ball.
That was a huge slap.
Huge stick in the air, that, wasn't it?
Ready to happen, sadly. Didn't make any connection. Not with the ball, and not with
the
players.
Did you want that to be connected? Are you endorsing violence? Sterling?
I'm not endorsing it, but if it does happen, and a crowd goes wild, I will not speak against it.
Spoken like a true rugby man there. Pass back to the defence and crossing it up to Zara Elvidge. Yep, she's on it. She's on it like a car bonnet. Back to the Prez.
Speaking about rugby, shout out to Adam Oki, who's currently in the hospital, having broken his fibula and tibia in the game, defending our honour on Thursday.
Lovely skill work there from Ella McCarthy. Sadly, 2-1, bit scary, but the ball belongs to
UCL. The umpire was not happy about the decision, was he?
No, he wasn't. Look at his arm in the air, indicating that it is UCL's ball.
There we go. Coming in number two, we've got Lottie.
Oh, wowee, that is a psychological play. Goodness me. Had me tricked there for a second.
And
but
some
again,
more
the
time
ball
the
has gone to Kings. Melissa Manley's defence have come up. We are into midfield and taking up to the right. Strong in Zara Elvidge's hands. And yet,
sadly, the ball has outrun her.
Yep. Yep. The defence is strong, I have to admit. King's defence, maybe they are emboldened by their three goals compared to UCL's one.
I do hope the UCL are not going to throw the towels in.
No, never.
Keep at it 100%.
Play strong until the end, yeah, give it your all. There we go, and in fact they have given it their all because there is another short corner for UCL.
Big moment for Hanny here. You can see the defence warming themselves up.
That's Helena
putting the masks on.
On the injection there, gains position.
Ready to receive that ball.
Nice and low.
Huge
suspense
bend.
Is creeping. And we're out. Stops.
Lovely
taken
receive.
In. Lovely slip off to the side. And stops.
Doesn't come to anything.
Stops by the goal. What is that? Oh, what is that? That is another short corner for UCL. My word.
Welcome to Varsity, the short corner special. Very loud here.
Oh, oh wow. Lovely bass from
UCL.
Everyone's
excited.
Very loud.
Pressure is on.
Very loud. And we're out again, once again taking it forward, straight in. That is a goal for UCL, finally! We're taking the replay, that's out, taken out.
Unfortunate deflection.
Taken forward by Ella McCarthy, that's next year's captain, and doing as a captain should, leading by example. Boom, that is a goal in the top left corner. Couldn't be saved by the Kings goalie. Here we go. There's current captain Kathy swapping on with Tabby Evans, number
straight
two.
Straight back into it from Kings.
There we go. Oh, Tanner, yes. And indeed, the energy has once again changed. This is a very changeable, capricious match.
The crowds are going absolutely wild.
Absolutely wild, yeah.
I think UCL have just realised the game is still on. And they can still potentially pull this back.
I think, do you know what? I'm quite excited because there we go. That is Helena, if I'm not mistaken, on the ball. Powerful strides. Speed, strength, agility. That's all that we've seen in this game. Good competitive spirit.
Sadly, speed, strength and agility, it may be. It's all about turning those qualities into points. At the end of the day, bit of cynicism there for you.
Yeah, that's Sterling on the cynicism. Sterling on the cynicism.
All day, every day, here for your enjoyment.
Breakfast, lunch and dinner, cynicism and sarcasm.
Ooh.
Stick tackle, I think. And
the ref
is picking
not
that
happy.
Up.
Umpire is going wild.
But it's UCL long advantage. And they are indeed taking it forward, but there is a lot of defence on the King's side. Eve taking it forward.
Umpire's throwing up his arms. Cannot believe it.
Okay.
Big slap, no fruition. Seema, our president, is currently getting very annoyed over the same anthem being sang time and time again.
Pressure is mounting. We have the ball. UCL have the ball.
We can see in number 16, Indy is currently getting ready to come on at any minute. Indy has been to three different universities, including Cape Town, New York, and now King's, where she's currently playing for Varsity, as you can see.
Kings have the ball. Taking up the left side, their left side. Attempt to tackle from Tabby Evans, and she has the ball. But it is back to Kings.
Cat taking the ball. No, giving it over back to Sarah. Sarah slaps it back into defence.
The defence are coming up into the
beautiful
field.
Slap.
Lovely.
Sadly intercepted.
From number 12.
Amy is straight on it along with Felice.
Very strong.
Felice,
who
currently has come back
lovely
from Singapore.
Transfer.
Been living 2 years in Singapore.
Nice transfer to Helena. But Kings are on it. Their defence is strong.
Oh, a little bit of a fight there. Well done, Lola.
Unfortunately, that is a Kings ball.
Lola's looking around. Big
pass
slap.
Back. Lovely. Not the best pickup. All the way to UCL. There we go, UCL.
Unfortunate interception.
Oh, goodness.
However, again, didn't get to do very much with that.
Some cheers for the captain.
And that is Indy coming on.
There we go. Straight in to King's stick.
But on cut. Another dribble straight down the middle. True, because it rhymes. In number 4, Adi is coming on. Swapping out for Felice. And in 11, Lily is back on. Swapping out for Lola. A lot of subbing going on here. We'd love to see the players on the bench being used.
Lots of subbing.
Well, you know, you got to keep the players...
warm, moving.
Well, you got to keep them on, give them time to play for the university and represent.
Unlucky
but simultaneously
touch.
Also, you know, give them time to rest on the sidelines.
Yeah.
There's no shame on being on the bench.
No.
Give yourself time to rest, come back on stronger. Give us those points.
UCL ball, taking it across, not necessarily the strongest hit, but there we go, we still have the ball in our possession.
The electric tension here is,
it is
palpable.
It is tense, absolutely. The rising and falling of the cheers.
I can't imagine the adrenaline pumping through our players right now. Knowing that every single minute counts here, every single minute might be the one that wins them this match.
That was very close. Nearly another King's goal. Goodness.
Your keeper does not seem fazed by any of this at all.
Mm.
Nice little waddle up and down the pitch.
Mm.
Staring everyone down.
It's all very tense. It feels like everyone is in the UCL defensive goal. There we go. Kings player taking it in. And reverse hit into someone's leg. Goodness. Who's that? Can we get a replay on that?
Oh dear.
That's number 11. I do believe that is, yep, that is Eve Hartley taking one for the team. A quite horrible one, in fact, I think.
As far as strong hits go, that was definitely one. Sadly, yeah. Slightly missed a ball there. End up in a player's, was it knee or shin?
No, I think it hit the ball, but the ball went into there.
Whoa, that's even worse.
Leg, yeah.
Actually, I don't even know anymore. What do you reckon is worse, impact from a ball or a stick?
I think it might be the stick, but... Because surely you tell me physics.
Well, I would say that the ball has a lower surface area when it hits.
Right.
Which mean a higher pressure.
Oh.
But a stick would also be traveling at a very high velocity, intending to be hitting said ball. So.
Whichever it is, I don't know. I think it's a UCL defensive short.
I would like to ask one of the hockey players such a question. Sadly, alas, I am not one.
And yet here you are, commentating like nobody's business.
Absolutely qualified for this job, I'm sure.
There is power and vengeance on UCL defensive mind.
Wonderful goal there. The ball just rolled into the goal of its own volition almost. It knew it belonged in the back of that net. Now we've got double your score, which is a very good sign. Do you reckon UC can pull this back, Mooney?
I have every faith in their abilities.
4-2.
UCL are back with a vengeance, but it's perhaps misguided vengeance. As we know, competition and competitive spirit can make play less precise, and perhaps that is happening on both ends, because I feel like King's players are also losing accuracy in passing, and there's a huge turnover.
Coming off, Lutty coming on.
UCL on the ball.
Seems to be like that gentleman's voice is now going.
It was gone. It was never really there. Yeah.
But you know, at least he was fervently supporting his own side, which is admirable, if not foolhardy.
There we go. That is a short corner to UCL. Perhaps they can take this opportunity to turn things around and even up the score a little bit more. Pressure is mounting.
Another short corner, would you believe it? Are we going to see a deep lunge here?
Yeah, I should hope so, yeah. I do believe all the goals scored this match have been from a short corner, no? Yeah, I think so. Very deep lunge that.
Very
straight in,
pass
come
there.
On. Come on, UCL, here we go. Ah, a bit of hesitation there from Ella McCarthy. And that hesitation is a crucial thing that leads to the loss of possession and the loss of a crucial goal.
It's a shame that was perfectly set up for a goal and yet just a
the
little
pressure.
Bit too short.
The pressure. Too short for a short corner.
Too short.
Yeah.
Too short of time.
But I do believe that is UCL back on it. And that is another... Oh no, not another short corner. It is a long corner. Different kind of corner. But a corner nonetheless.
I don't know. Is it a corner? Taken from the line.
Yeah. I think it used to be different. Well, you wouldn't know because you don't play hockey, so.
I know the rules very well, indeed, as you can tell from my immaculate professional commentary.
It's King's ball.
Biding time here in the back. Very accurate passing is what we're demonstrating here.
Well kept in there from... Oh, no. No. It wasn't well kept in, no. Kings have the ball, and they pass it across into the D. And UCL defence is tight.
And hit it. Right up the pitch.
Picked up from Prez.
Made a lot of ground, but sadly lost possession.
be on the ball again.
It's always good not to be pressured though in your own half, is it? Not for long by the looks of it.
It seems to be her signature move, that spin out. She's taking it forward and into the... That is a goal! She's made up for that last short corner with an excellent swing and not a miss, because that was stunning. Stunning to behold. And we are at 3-2. No, we're not at 3-2. We're at 3-4. Yeah.
3-4.
Yep, we are at 3-4. Thank you for clarifying. Tannoy!
It is Tannoy time indeed. I must say, that was very well done.
Very invigorating.
From UC's.
And UCL seem to have a new lease for life. But Kings still have their defence on. But there we go. There we go. The player's stronger, though. The player's faster. Energetic.
It is incredible to see such a close battle.
I know.
Not letting either side slip away just too far.
Short corner. There we go. The shorts. The shorts keep coming. Goodness. Oh, no, it wasn't a short, no. My bad. It was a long corner or something, I don't know.
Kings are fighting hard to get into that box, but it seems a little bit impenetrable at times. It's very much loaded with purple.
There we go.
Kings
UCL
are sprinted back
out
to roadside.
Lovely pass across. Let's get it out of the danger zone. There it is.
Swapping wings.
Taking up. Lovely pass up.
Beautiful marking there by number four, Addy.
Stopped again. That's Helena, I do believe. Lovely tackle, but that is a UCL ball.
Very aggressive tackle there from Chrissy.
Not a legal tackle. No.
Very aggressive.
Lovely but illegal. Ah, such is life.
That is a quote there. Lovely but illegal.
Bit slow on pick up there. There we go, but that is out of pitch. Tensions are indeed rising as UCL are striving to get it to equalise. And yet midfield seems to be a tricky region. See, we're passing back to defence. Let's get it up the pitch.
There's a lot of play on the wings today.
Yeah.
Tactical wingers play. Working very, very hard.
That was, again, not so lovely and yet again illegal. The
looks
worst
to me
of the
like
combo.
Kings are very much fighting tooth and nail for that ball. They do not want it in their own half.
Yeah.
Absolutely do not.
Let's get it up. There we go. Unfortunately, no one to pick up. Butter Kings player.
Tried to defend that ball, sadly, with their own feet.
Nope.
Alas, it's not full ball. In number nine, Felice.
Lovely defence from...
Sadly, not able to make
Julia.
That happen.
Bit of a kerfuffle going on in the middle. Not sure whose ball it is. It's UCL's ball. Molly Woodburn on the ball, taking it forward. Lovely. We are finally in the midfield and up the field. Two up the field. We are now out of the field.
Well, that ball was passed, if nothing, then with a lot of vigour.
Yep. You can really start to feel the passion emanating off the pitch now.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. I'm feeling it in a box right here.
Yep.
And I'm standing
nervous.
20 metres away from the pitch.
Yeah. COVID, social distance.
There's a lot of pointing, a lot of strategising on King's side.
Yeah, lots of defence from the King's side. Their defensive D looks like a sea of reds. And there we go, we are so close by the D, let's get it in.
Ooh.
The foot, let's pick it up, there we go, that is a foot.
Unlucky Grace.
Against Kings, it's UCL's ball.
I'm seeing a lot of reds in the box.
defence is
doing their best to stop UCL from making any ground whatsoever.
Tooth-biting match, this. Nail-biting match, not tooth-biting match.
You can bite your teeth all you want to.
I am biting my teeth. That's how nervous I am.
Jittering in nervousness.
Yeah, absolutely. Goodness me.
You can see, time and time again, you see us striking. They're trying to get in there, trying to penetrate our defence, get through to the goal, and yet stopping just short. Mm. Just short. Keeping up the pressure, though, not allowing Casey to rest at all. These players are going to be very tired going to Vault later. I reckon it's going to be 1 point each before they're out on the floor.
Yeah, easily.
Which is standard for UC, even when they're at their best.
That was nearly a goal, but perhaps the pressure got to the Kings player and did not actually get into the goal. Oh, that was a stick straight to a UC player's stick from Kings. And that leads to Ella McCarthy on the ball, UCL possession. We're going to cross it through. Lovely, over to Iona. Lovely bit of movement. Getting up, picked it up. UCL have the ball. Stopped by Kings' defence. Fortress, this defence. Which is why every moment to gain possession and breakthrough is crucial. Kings on the ball.
Grayson Crowe.
But Julia.
And it stopped just short of the D. Interception by Kat. Showing us how we do it in Wales.
That's lovely movement there.
In number 14, Amy coming on for Amy.
That's some great wing movement from Zara Elvidge.
Beautiful pass. Last well marked from UC. I'm itching to just commentate on the tannoy.
You can't see that into the mic. There we go, up the right wing. Again, intercepted. It feels like a game of non-stop interceptions over here. What do you think, Sterling?
Oh yes, the marking is very much man on man. They're right up next to each other, shoulder to shoulder, not letting them have any space of their own. Whatsoever.
Very much a match of equal matches.
It's a lot of matches.
A lot of matches. Lovely touch there. Again, interception. I think the pressure is getting to the players. There's a 16 for UCL. But perhaps tiredness is setting in as well. What do we think?
As we're nearing the end, we can see all the players are getting very, very anxious.
Yeah.
Very anxious. I think especially in the UC side, knowing they have to get that score.
It's
they
important.
Have to.
Yeah.
And yet on the Kings side, equally knowing they can't allow themselves to lose as much as a single goal.
Missed opportunity there, but no worries because it goes into another UCL player. Picked up by Ella McCarthy. Maintains possession, it is still out of ball.
Lily there getting very upset with the UC player.
Lovely hit across, picked up by Lindsay. There we go, all on the reverse stick, did you see that?
Wonderful stop there. Up to Chrissy, the dribbling down the middle. Given to Kings. Nice, calm, collected. Big slap. And almost a goal.
That was very scary.
Inches away from the post.
Yeah.
And yet for UC, that might mean win or lose.
UCL's chance coming back with vigour. Lovely movement of the ball from President Julia. Still moving, oh dear.
Wonderful interception there.
Had a tad too long.
Karma collected pass to Gracie in 12.
Oh, unlucky.
Well done, Lily.
King's on the ball.
In number 6, Chrissy.
Taking it to centre.
Dribbling between two players. However, nice stopped by there. The third.
UCL ball. What's going on? There's a fair bit of booing happening.
Apparently, people are not happy with the umpire's decision.
Yeah.
It would not seem like a popular decision. However, umpires are not known for making a popular decision.
Mm.
Hit out by Cat.
UCL ball.
And that is the end of the game.
Wow.
Well done, Kings.
That is a win to Kings. Unfortunate.
You can see the dejected faces of UC players who gave it their all, albeit not quite bringing the victory back.
Still huddling, still joining together as a team. And still staying strong in team spirit. It was a good game, it was a great game. Lots of dynamic play, and the team spirit stays strong.
All three, Kings. Victors of 2022 Women's Hockey Varsity, King's College London.
A very hearty congratulations to King's. Perhaps UCL will be able to make up for this unfortunate loss. Only a tiny loss, only missed it by a hair. Perhaps the men will be able to make up for it at their game at 8:30.
You'll see everyone joining the celebrations.
Yeah, look at them go.
We love to see even from the UCL side congratulating their players.
Strong team spirit.
A lot of sportsmanship from this both teams.
Supporting the women, showing a lot of love, a lot of affection. And there is our captain, Kathy. Leading them back onto the pitch.
Yeah, it has been wonderful commentating tonight with you.
Yep, it's been a pleasure.
Keeping the profanity away from the commentator's box.
It was very, very limited, if none, in fact.
Absolutely.
just very funny.
A lot of mixing up players, a lot of mixing up rules, and plenty of absolute London. Terrible chat. Thank you very much, and enjoy the men's game, which is soon to follow. Good night.
Stay tuned. Bye.
All right, it's KCL versus UCL Men's Hockey Varsity 2022. My name is Patrick. I'm so, so excited to welcome you all back to some more cracking hockey.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the UCL team on the mic. Myself, Angelier, we're delighted to be here at Levi on this beautiful, beautiful Saturday evening. Cannot wait for a king smashing of Strand Polytechnic. And on the UCL representation on the desk today, I'm joined by none other than
Matthew Punt from the UCL third 11, joining Andrew Lee, captain of the second team here tonight. We're really excited to watch what's looking like a great game of hockey. Women's game went well, but we're excited to see the men's play now.
I think we're going to crack on and get introducing the teams.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for some more men's hockey. I'm very, very excited. I hope you are as well. I'm outnumbered by UCL up here, so I want some noise for you Kings on, yes? Let's introduce now the teams on the field. Introducing the mighty KCL men's hockey team led by
Mr. Sexy Big Slaps himself, Alex Tan. Commanding the net is Tesco Ham enthusiast Antonio. And securing the defense, we have Golar, Mr. Kim, Dan Murray and Tom Grout. Moving further up, we've got Money Marnix, Matisse and Thirlby. Go check out his most recent EP on all streaming platforms. And with Dan Folger and Fresher Aiden rounding up starting 11. The bench is filled to the brim with talent as well. President Alex Huseman, Harrison Slade, Ryan Lyon, Jay Connor and Joe Costello. Over now to the Girl Street Games at UCL.
And now for the mighty, mighty purple. Here we go, no particular order, number 5. Give it up for Luke Cargan. Number 8, Matthew White. Number 9, Sahir Patel. Number 10, Oliver Gadsby. Number 4, the Magic Man, Cav. Number 16, Clement. Number 3, Tiny Ed. Number 7, Rahul. Number 15, Toby Middleton. 18, Noah Martel. 14, Nick Gill, fresh Nick Gill. Number 2, the former captain, Elliot Dennis. 13, Zane, the future president. Miles, number 6, and finally, but absolutely not least, at the ripe old age of 41, Amir Khan. Here we go.
Back here with the live stream. It's almost start. It's almost pushback. But I'm on the end.
Game.
I'm not too sure. We're just coming back off a women's victory. We'll be going to be riding that high. It was a great game though, wasn't it, that ladies game?
It was a close game, but I have to say, UCL, just a few weeks ago, they had battered the Kings side 5-1. And as far as I'm concerned, the only person I'm worried about from Kings, having played against him myself, is that number 13, the skinhead out front. We're going to keep him quiet. We've got to keep him quiet, and after that we'll be fine. Last time we played, it was 5-1. And I have to say, the two varsities previously, both times UC have been on the winning side, winning 6-1 last year, and the time previously 3-0. So the boys are coming confident here tonight, and it's going to be an interesting game, but I'm confident in the Bows and Purple.
And we're off. UC are coming off the back of 2 varsity wins, but we are hungry at Kings.
And that's what I like to see, Aaron from the start. I love this play down the sideline, down the right sideline. And those are sleeveless kit of the boys in purple.
Seems like you weren't paying your child workers enough.
We'll let that sit for a bit. Here we go, into the D, the first penetration on many, I'm sure.
It's a good pickup now from Alex Dan. He's looking for his options. Golar now trying to work his way out of congestion. It's picked up by UC though, they're in front of goal.
And we have a far post now.
Very strong from Antonio. He's closing down that distance very quickly. That's a UC ball.
This is an excellent start from UCL. Nice and aggressive. This is how they play. This is how they win.
Dan Fogger now piling on the pressure. The UC backs calm under it though.
And that number 4 opted for the skins today. The only one from the UC crowd to opt for the skins. And funny enough, he is the GB's most promising prospect.
As still, listed on their on 2 years in a row.
I know, as listed on their website. He's at 3 England caps now, and he'll be commanding the back line, and nothing will be getting past him tonight.
It's very impressive, but I'm gonna think we're gonna sit here and hope that things are able to get past. Golar now looking for that ball up the line. He's got no space though. UC close him down. Matisse fighting hard for that ball, but there's no pickup. King's ball now, called by the umpire.
As we wait for the King's ball, I've got one question for the King's commentary. Patrick, of why course. Aren't you playing tonight?
Well, they thought that my vocal cords would be better used here than shouting on a pitch. Although I was getting pretty hoarse cheering for the ladies earlier. I just felt it more appropriate that I be up here and grace everybody on this live stream with my sultry tones. Alex Tan now, ironing enthusiast and big shop lover. Golar moving on.
And there he is, number four, Matthew Cavalier, all the way from Bolton, cleaning up the mess around the back. And I have to paint the picture tonight, boys. This is a UC team on the verge of the treble, of the domestic treble. They've won the league, they've won the cup, and now they're going for Varsity. There's nothing that can stop them.
It would be very impressive, but I think of all the sides that they're going to face today, this is the team that's going to do the most damage to them.
And in goal.
We're fighting hard in front of goal. Umpire's not going to call anything. Oh, no. My mistake. Yes, she does.
And there we go. In goal is Ed Peachy, nicknamed the Sieve for his erratic performances. But he seems to be in command today. And, you know, given that this is his second Varsity, I feel like he's going to be in command today. And we've gone out to the right. Playing around the back, it's the bread and butter of UC. Yeah, this is typical, this is what we want to see.
Good man for Belby there. Remember, everybody drop his EP, it's excellent. Dan Murray now tripped in the back line. The umpire's calling it in King's favour, just outside the D. Belby takes the ball quickly, injects it in. Fresh Ray was looking for that ball.
And that's what I like to
now,
see.
Picking it up. UC have the ball now, he's driving hard.
Driving down the line, there was a bit of contradiction amongst the umpires here, but it's UC on the ball now. Here we go, slip to the left, and he's in here, and it's got to be, oh, UC can count their lucky charms, but that is not 1-0 UC.
UCL are playing to their heathen gods for this good fortune. I'm afraid, though, the true god will not allow for any more of this, and neither will KCLHC.
Typical KCL chat, bringing back to their religion, of course. The boring chat that we are the godless students of Gower Street.
You guys literally invented eugenics. So,
no further comment on that.
Yeah, thought so.
What can we expect to see from the KCL? Obviously, we're in the same tier, but KCL won't quite manage to secure promotion like our boys in purple are. And that's an awkward 16 from the boys in red.
Of Dan Murray feeling the pressure, unfortunately.
And we take that quite rightfully a foul, just at the edge of the D. Number 41 the ball there, and there we go,
very
in the D.
Very impressive pick up there.
Oh, it's a wild swing. And what I want to see from the boys in purple, I just want to see them settle down a bit, because we all know that this is a team on the up. You know, in the semi-finals of the Cup, they all managed to thrash Kings 5-1. Kings, if they can even deserve that. We prefer the name Strampoli, isn't that right, Matthew Punt?
That is correct. Speaking to Sahil before the match, he said whoever settles first is going to win this game. That's what happened last year, and that's what's going to happen today.
And it's attack now from the boys in purple with their tank tops. Questionable choice, but I don't mind it because they're in the D, and they take the shot, and it's just wide.
Dan Fogel almost getting his head taken clean off there by that wild UC ball.
And who is that
Get
keeper from King? Who is that keeper from Kings?
Big man Antonio, VP of American football as well. He's a man of many talents.
American football sounds like he's not committed. He doesn't want it. Sprinting for the out-of-bounds ball.
He's hungry. A very, very imaginative attack coming out from UC as well. The typical Polytechnic stuff. It's almost as imaginative as being a brown man named Patel. Dan's loving the floor there, but he gets back up quickly. UC now injecting on the D.
Some wild shots from the boys in purple. I want to see a bit more composure, a few more touches around the D, and then no doubt we'll repeat the score 5-1. I mean, last year was 6-1. I heard some predictions from the boys, and they're feeling very confident. They haven't even prepared properly for this game. You know, word in the street is several of their team, they played Saturday League. They played a pushback at 2 p.m. because they don't care. The Kings have nothing. Last year, 6-1.
The Kings have nothing, do they? Alex Tan is scrapping hard. Unfortunately, a little bit too hard for the umpire's liking. It moves on to a UC free hit.
And here's a man of note on the ball right now with the aerial across the pitch. It's number two, Elliot Dennis. And he's a controversial figure because last year he was the captain, of course, but word on the street is he will be defecting to Imperial College London next year. And both Kings and UCL can agree and unite in rivalry to agree that there's nothing worse than an Imperial student. Isn't that right, Patrick?
No, that's actual facts. I cannot argue with that.
We all hate
Imperial.
We hate the Kensington Monotechnic. And honestly, he's dead to me.
God, not even a Polytechnic.
It's a Monotechnic.
So low.
It's a Monotechnic. And you know, the other thing about Elliot Dennis, which I like to cite, is that he had the gall to drop the current captain, Luke Cargan, number 5.
You know, he dropped
Luke Cargan last year, and Luke Cargan finds himself as captain. So no doubt Elliot must have been worried about his place, but thankfully his aerials kept him on the pitch tonight.
He's earned his spot, apparently. I heard he applied for the role of Mr. Tickle. His arms are just being just an unholy length. I think the audition director was meant to call him back, but that was about 3 years ago. So hopefully he's not getting too bummed out by that.
At the ripe height of 6'9", he's not quite made the cut for Mr. Tickle, but I must direct the conversation to our coach on the sidelines, none other than Asif. He's got legions of experience as a coach, leading the 2018 Rums ladies squad to a Varsity victory. Obviously weren't successful last night, but tonight he's eating the boys in purple, and here they go, down the left wing, driving down now, nice and strong. But this is a slightly disappointing start from the boys in purple, because I know the intention was to set the pace nice and early, but I've got to say there's a substitution for Kings right now, but I want to see Asif roll the dice a bit, maybe mix things up with the formation, because the first few minutes haven't quite gone the way I'm sure the boys in purple would have hoped.
It's our very, very good friend Harrison Slade, known fondly as Drunk Jesus or Homeless Jesus. He has bought his ticket to Ipswich in preparation for tonight's shenanigans. To fill you boys in, one night after a very, very long and intense sport night, got on the train, woke up in Ipswich the next morning. How he got there, he doesn't know. But he's prepared this time, so he'll know where he'll be tonight.
And there he is, Luke Cargan on the edge of the D, dribbling around, but it's not quite managed. But it's sort of worked out for UCL, and they're in the D now.
Matisse scrapping hard, our Belgian signing. Very odd that their country proudly displays a statue of a urinating naked toddler, but we don't hold it against them.
Of course we don't. And we know Matisse, of course, from his time as the mixed captain of KCL. I have faced him up against it on the pitch himself. And you know what? Subpar, to be honest. That's my assessment of him.
Subpar. Why are you not on the pitch then? Go show him how it's done.
I have to say, I've experienced some problems with the knees. But I would say, as captain of the tiers myself, we have actually faced against this Kings squad in the Sem Cup. That the UCL soundly beat them, the ones 5-1 in the semi-finals. It was a close game. On another day, we would have won. But it was a 3-2 loss for us, sadly.
Not going to beat the wall that is Mr. Kim, though.
And this is UCL setting up for another attack. Round the back. This is what they do best. Back to Elliot Dennis. Here we are. Back again to Nick.
Nice and composed. Here we go. Up to Cav, the magic man. Round the back with his sleeves. No doubt he's chugged a few Red Bulls tonight.
Now Nick has plenty of space here. Just what he wants to operate. Back to Matt Cav.
Here we go. Circle penetration into the D now. Perfect. And here we go. It's a chance for the boys in blue.
Picked up a poor lack of communication there from UCL. Almost fucked them up there.
Here we go.
Wild shot there from Mr. Patel.
No, he's taking out the umpire there. Everything all right.
Apparently, Mr. Patel feels the need to express his anger towards the umpire.
Oh.
Rogue ejection. Matisse takes it almost to the testes.
I think that shows the lack of composure from the King's man.
Or just the pure commitment to willing to put his future on the line for KCL MHC. Would have been very impressive.
Talk to me about the King's season, Patrick. What's it been like? Obviously, the boys in purple secured promotion. They won the cup. What did Kings do after losing semi-finals?
Well, most unfortunately, we weren't able to move beyond third. We were fighting very, very, very hard. Unfortunately, our last two games were against Chichester. It was very tough for us in that league, but we fought really, really hard. We've had such a strong team. off the back, mostly of that man who just lost the ball, Dan Fargo, who hasn't seen as much play as he may have liked to so far, having scored 900% more goals than the next top goal scorer at Kings.
Just come off the post there. Pass going out. It's now for Kings 16. And what we're going to see now is UC set the press, set the high press. And now we mentioned Kings, you know, coming up to difficulty in Chichester. But of course, Chichester is a team that UC have dealt with in the past.
All I can say is congratulations to you, because Chichester looked like a very, very tough team to try and deal with.
No problem for the boys in purple. Absolutely none. Didn't even break a sweat.
You sure? So unfortunately, you lot have got to sully yourself with like Frenchmen and whatnot in order to win. And I think we'll take the moral high ground on that one and be a Frenchmanless team rather than do it for the win. Although here now, we will do just about anything. We will discuss it along the way, some of us. What would we do to win? Alex Tan commenting that he would suck off the devil in order to win. I hope he hasn't had to do that, though. I'm hoping just pure skill will allow him to do it.
I've got nothing to say about that.
And that's an excellent pick by England's most promising.
His stick does look very throwable, though.
We'll take that. It's the first roll of the dice from Asif. Coach Asif, number 10, Oliver Gadsby coming on for Tiny Ed Parker, number 3. And I have to say, the sleeveless vest of the UC, they made them look brilliant. Of course, it's sleeves number 4, Matthew Cavalier. As I said, England's most promising prospect since 1980. And there we go. A long ball into the midfield, not quite finding its mark now.
Fresh road now on the ball, trying to work his pressure, man. Dan Murray moving on to Matisse. Slight difficulties there with Tan. He got a bit distracted looking at the substitution, perhaps. Moving on now back to the UCL backline. I heard last year, right? I was watching the broadcast from last year. Apparently, Mr. Patel was saying that if he won, he was going to get Team UCL tattooed on his chest.
I know. I haven't been able to confirm whether or not this is carrying on for the second year. But number 9, Sahir Patel, is the man to watch.
Well, Mr. Patel, I hope if you do get that tattooed. Disgusting for Yusuf Ford. I hope he's getting a card there. That was filthy. Just taking out the ankles of Dan Murray. But as I was saying with Mr. Patel, I hope that if, God forbid, he gets it, I hope it's expensive and it gets infected.
I mean, that's just unsavoury comments. And, you know, from UCL, I can just say, can't we, Matthew Punt? We don't condone such comments. And, you know, no matter what the outcome is today, we hope the welfare of both teams is the most important thing. And we absolutely don't hope that a tattoo gets infected. And that's a disgusting, unsavoury comment from the King's men. But what can we expect? We can't expect anything more.
No, we're going low this year. Going way down low. But it's all in the name of good fun.
All in the name of good fun. But in good fun, we've got a short corner for UCL. And this is what we like to see.
Now, the interesting thing about this AstroTurf is that last year, the first two injections were scuffed. And so Matt Cav ended up deciding to slap the ball in as his injection. It will be interesting to see if he does that again this year.
It looked like a rogue strategy, that one.
Yeah, you didn't quite realise that was legal, did you, Andrew?
Well, it wasn't the strategy, but he stepped up for the short again this year, and we're going to see what the plans. We don't have the German import. What we do have? We do have two Belgium imports in Clemil and Elliot Dennis. And we know Elliot is a prominent flicker, and he does look to be lining up at Castle One. And here we go. Up to Gadsby is stopping now. It's Elliot on the flick, and takes round one, and that should be another short corner. Absolutely. That's what I like to see from the umpire. Sense for umpiring. And if you ask me, that's a card.
Time's getting called, though. What's happening here? The man known simply as Jay being told, I think, to hold his horses just a little bit, coming on a bit too early after the short corner.
And that's what I like to see from the umpires, taking control of the game. Unruly stuff from KCL.
I wish he picked a better letter, though.
Jay. He's been sent to walk away. What a walk of shame.
Unfortunately,
sort of,
for drunk Jesus.
Lame jog to the halfway line. The umpires are having words, and I hope they're not holding back, because honestly, the only thing we've seen from KCL so far has been disgusting.
Disgusting? How could you say such a thing?
And here we go. UCL's first goal from last year came from something similar like this, I believe.
You are right.
We've got to hope for a repetition.
What we're hoping for is just another poor control here from UCL Flicker. Castle 1-1 looking to be the target.
It's the sleeves. And he's out. And he's through.
Top work from Alex Huseman. Redemption time for him. He's going for a personal best of playtime in this match. Quality for the one-runner.
It's a long corner. It's a quick long corner from UCL. And they're into the D. There's an appeals for foot, but...
Yeah, it's not. It's not given.
Here, but here we go.
The short corner not given by the umpire. Antonio in goal, coming in clutch for us, getting his body straight behind the ball. Quality stuff. It's a 16 now for Kings. Mr. Kim taking that ball. Moving on to Tom Grout. He's looking for his signature aerial. Unfortunately, doesn't find Jay, but he's turned on the wheels. Money Marnix now looking for the ball. He's driving into that space. Looking for Ryan Lai at the top now. Young signings here as well, all at the top. What is the call there from the umpire? Is it looking like a long corner?
And there he is, number 9, Sahir Patel, onto the pitch now. He is the danger man.
Very strange for a brown man to be so tall.
Nothing on from Kings there, really struggling. They lack imagination, Kings, to be honest. There's not much going on.
Yeah, the extent of your chat is, Kings is a poly. It's not particularly...
And here we go! Oh, there it is! The first goal of many! I bet who else? Number 9.
And that's the dynamism we've come to expect from this UC side. Speed and finesse.
We have the replay there. It's a long ball and the keeper bottles it around the back. And UCL, the predators, they sense the danger. They smell the goals. They just wanted it more. And they get that first goal. That's going to be crucial. That's really going to open up the game, I think. And it's going to force Kings to attack. Because so far, their tactics have just been to play around the back. And look, they're rattled. Their right back is just giving away the ball for free. And it's now a UCL possession. And let's see what they do with it. They're playing around the back now. Bread and butter of UCL's game, as mentioned. Fully confident. Number 13, the danger.
On the pressure, so is Jay Canner.
The danger man in the middle, got nothing on. It's a sort of square, incisive ball. That's what I like to see from the Nick girl, number 14. Number 10 now, Oliver Gadsby. Bringing it out, and that's all right. We don't mind that. A little bit of creativity now that we're nil up. And what I want to see from the boys in purple is to really assert their dominance.
Margola now going for the aerial. Finds, unfortunately, nobody, but Money Marnix is fighting hard for it. He carries on. He's driving down into space. UC sticks all over him. UCL apparently a fan of gang operations. Dan Folger now piling on the pressure at the top, forces the defense back out in the other direction. Jake Allen with the ball. Dan still fighting hard here. It's picked up once again by the UCL backline.
It's diplomatic stuff here. Now we're to number 14, Fresher Nick. He's moved it on to number 5. The skipper, Luke Cargan, who's won a free hit, and he's taking it quickly, driving towards the D.
I've heard Luke Cargan's a bit of a fan of massage guns. Is that correct?
A fan of the whom, sorry?
Massage guns.
Oh, I couldn't possibly call him, but you know, he is coming back from a long injury, which has sidelined him.
See, and I thought it was just the only way he could pleasure a woman.
Couldn't possibly comment on Luke Cargan's medical conditions. I have to do that up to his personal doctors.
Good interception there for Alistair. Picked up hard by Matisse. He's now driving down that baseline, turning those Belgian wheels on. Unfortunately, couldn't keep the ball under control. Taking
just won the
back
ball out. It's number 15, Toby Middleton, the twos boy himself. He was once one of my freshmen, and I had to move him up because he was just that good. We all remember, of course, at UC, that famous victory in Portsmouth where Toby Middleton ran the pitch and produced the goal. And let's just hope he's able to produce something similar today against the Kingsmen. And it's number 14, Nick Gill, coming back on. Off for Clermont, one of our Belgian imports, who's going to be hoping to make a difference today.
Josh Thirlby now, EP releaser, fighting for the ball. Looking for a flick through. Dan Folger now. looking to get that ball under control.
Oh, and
straight out to Aiden from the goalkeeper. That was his shot. Dan Folger goes down. Big fan on the floor, unfortunately, and it's picked up by the UC defense. But now the pressure is still getting piled on.
I've got to say, that's an element of diving for the Kings man, Ed Peachy. You know, even though he's nicknamed the Sim, it's all a bit of fun because realistically he is rock solid around the back. And it's number five, Luke Curry, around the back. Now he's on the ball. Let's see what he does. Plays across the D, a raking ball. And here we go, in the D now. Let's see what UC do with this. Here we go, shot. And I've got to say, KCL really riding their luck here because it's been all UCL. There's been some half chances for Strand Polytechnic, but realistically, you know, nothing's come to fruition for them.
We are truly privileged here to watch this creative and dynamic hockey that UCL are putting on display tonight. And clinical defending there.
A little bit of pressure from number 13, but realistically, he's got nothing. What I want to see him channel Skinhead Rooney and sort of 2 foot one of the UC boys in power, because that would be funny. Because realistically at this point there's nothing on for the Kings men. It's all UCL. And here we go, around the 25, passing around the back. Composure. I think Kings here, you know, if we wanna talk about tactics, they've gone for a sort of undisciplined half-court press. They don't mind bringing up to the halfway. But you know, I think the boys in purple have prepared for every likelihood under the leadership of Asif, of course. And here we go.
Must be straight out of training ground, wasn't it?
You know, we like to press from the front, and giving a 16 to the Kings, why not? They look nervous, to be honest. They look nervous on the ball. Here we go.
Andrew, what do you think of the UCL and KCL atmosphere here tonight?
I've got to say, there's only one question remains for the Kingsmen, and Patrick, you may be able to answer it, but my question is this a library?
No, this isn't, but I've not heard a whole lot from those Donnies down there in purple. Very gaudy colour, I must say. But, you know, it's not a particularly exciting game. Nobody's doing anything too much.
I don't need
this. We've had some excellent chat. I know you were watching the ladies' game. We were all over it. We were singing songs, drinking many beers, although, you know, it's a bit shit boring, I can't lie.
I've got to apologise for the foul language of the Kingsmen there. Obviously at UCL we don't condone such foul and disgusting and distasteful language.
You haven't learned enough words.
They've got no filters in the Strand Polytechnic as we enter the D for the UCL men. And I have to say, God, that is disgusting! I hate that, that's a con. Number 13.
Unbelievable, he's tripped over his own feet there, and apparently the umpire thinks that was somehow Dan Folger's fault.
We've got a replay there, and you can clearly see he's almost a slight kick to the shin of the UCL player there as we're into the D.
Dan Murray's gone down. An unfortunate injury from there. Didn't quite see what happened there. Time has been called by the umpires to see if he's okay.
And I think the call is a UCL short corner, which we love to see. What I want from this game is really to see two or three short corners to be converted. I know we've got flickers in Elliot number 2 and YC number 8. You know, you may remember the sort of loyal fans from last year, number 8, Matthew White, look sexy, play sexy, but he doesn't seem to have stepped up to the castle this year. It appears to be number 2, Elio Dennis again. So let's see what they've got in store for us.
Typical of a UC man to be literally named White.
He is from Hong Kong. And no comment from Patrick there.
It explains so much.
Here we go.
Takes it himself, passes it out now.
Oh, I love this.
The wall of Mr. Kim, not getting
penetrated. Oh, there we go! Another goal from UCL. Kitties couldn't deal with the intricate passing in the D from UCL, and there's a slow drop back. I just want to see a celebration from the boys in purple because it's 2-0 now, and realistically, it's all over from the Kings. They've got nothing. Where's their leaders? They got nothing. Oh, they dribble straight forward, but it's just not composed. They just seem rattled as they dribble down the left here. But oh, okay, Elemental stick tackle. Oh, here we go. I don't want this. Oh, it's a green card for number 80, Noah Martel. He's a fresher, but he's in second year. And Noah Martel, ask him any question about Chelsea FC.
Yeah, I was reading his profile, actually. It was very, very boring. I was amazed that the entirety of UCLHC can't find a way to make that man's personality even remotely interesting.
I can't believe that Kings have nothing better to do than read the UCL social media post, but Kings enter into the D here, some sort of weird 3D skill. And for those from Kings who don't understand what 3D is, that means when it comes up from the pitch and it results in nothing. And now it's a UCL ball round from back and we're in the comfort zone here. Oh, a little bit of nerves there from our left back. Is that number 15? I believe that's Toby Middleton. He's awful, honestly. He is dreadful.
Yeah, it was pretty poor out there.
He's from Bournemouth, something like that. He was trying to tell me where he's from, but honestly, I lost interest. But you know what? I went to Bournemouth once, and they had a great fish and chips. It rained quite a lot, but they had a great fish and chips, and I enjoyed it thoroughly. But the person I was with actually asked for a poached fish, which is pretty traumatic, but you know, that says a lot about Bournemouth that they're happy to do that.
This man apparently has the same amount of personality as those fish. And yeah, the same hockey skills as well. Missed trapping the ball out there. Very simple ball he just missed.
The King's chant fizzles out there to 16-4 for UCL. A little bit of game management there from Cam, taking his time, slowing the game down. You know, I came here expecting to see a slow game from KCL, sort of really regressive hockey, trying to stop UCL from playing as we enter the D, but it's a missed trap from that man, number 9, Sahir Patel, up front with those bright orange shoes. God, they must be new. They must be new for this day. I've just had confirmation that the score is indeed 2-0 for UCL. What's the score, Patrick?
It's 2-0 to UCL.
And that comes with the Kingsman himself.
It does. I mean, we're all seeing this live. It would be very unprofessional of me to just lie about it.
That's a wonderful pick from Zane Baracha.
It's a hard blow from the umpire there. You got to feel like that man on the left wing, he's got to be coming close to a green card, because there have been some interesting stick tackles, and you know, I won't comment on it because the umpires can do what they want, but as a qualified level 1 unassessed umpire myself, according to England Hockey, that is disgusting and worthy of a yellow.
Unassessed, huh? Alex Tan now looking for the skills, trying to get his pass to his men. Unfortunately, he just gets surrounded by Kingsmen.
And here we go, that was Matthew Cavalier, number 4, cleaning up around the back, and it's gone all the way to the keeper. Not
Dan Murray's so calm on the ball, even when he's on the D.
This is going to be taken by Zane, next year's UCL men's hockey president. Famous for being picked up by his mother in his first varsity.
That's pretty poor.
And he's just got to be happy to be on the pitch, because I'm not sure, I wasn't sure. I had to ask, I had to confirm whether he actually plays hockey, because he's just really not, he's not really played much this year, but you know, as the future president, as of Tuesday, he's got to be delighted.
You elected that man as your president?
He recently elected on president with our fully democratic process. I'm not sure Kings, to explain this to the Kings viewers, democratic means we take a vote amongst the general population of the society, and whoever has the most votes, which means more than the other people, they become president. As another UCL penetration there into the D. What's the call here, Patrick? I wasn't paying attention. I was too busy talking about Zane Perach and how his presence is going to be great. I'm thinking JFK. I
hope he doesn't suffer the same fate.
If he does, it will be from a King's man, and you know,
it'll be all about the Varsity, wouldn't it? Just gonna take out the leadership before Varsity, knock you right down. Not that we do it.
You know what? I say bring on LBJ.
You know, apparently he held like meetings in the White House bathrooms for particular reasons to do with his last name. It was quite funny.
I'm not gonna speculate about that, but if you've got anything to say, Patrick, about the name LBJ, you can say that yourself, because I'm not quite clear.
First, we're gonna watch this!
And it's another goal for UCL. That's a poacher's goal, you gotta say. Whatever that was, and we're gonna see a replay here. As it's a sort of speculative ball across the D, and it's just a simple deflection. Kings aren't as switched on in the D as UCL, and it's 3-0 UCL. And we're gonna be delighted that Acid's gonna be delighted that. Look at him with his with his yellow bobble hat. Passing off some instructions to the captain on the bench. He's right now. But look at this, the high press. UCL, clearly, they want to make it 10. Double digits. I said it last year. I'll say it again. Anything less than double digits, and I'll be disappointed. It's UCL on the ball now, and that's disgusting. It's disgusting holding from KCL, because clearly they decide they can't play the stick and ball, and they decide to play the man. And you know what? What is that a yellow card?
I believe that is, Andrew. I believe that is.
My. I couldn't tell if that's a yellow card, but no Kings player appears to be running off.
It's a bit unclear from the umpires what the call is.
There was a clear showing of the yellow card, but the speculation is, oh, and he's sort of drawing off. He seems not be aware that his team is 3-0 down and that the time only starts when his bum is in his seat. Who is that man there?
Josh Snow will be making his way off the field, demonstrative of his passion. He's willing to put everything into this game, even if it is a little bit dodgy.
As we enter the closing stage of the first half, the score is 3-0 UCL, and it's 10 men on the pitch for Kings. Strand Polytechnic, in other words.
When are you going to get some new chat? I just don't understand. You're just going to lean
Patrick,
into
remind,
this one
remind
chat.
Remind me. Let's talk about the QE times rankings for university. Where were Kings?
Oh, I couldn't tell you.
Not in the top 25. And where were UCL? That's right, in the top 10. That's all I've got to say.
And yet you still have lower employment rates than we do. Shocking. You've got a whole song about it, and it's a lie.
That's a short corner for UCL. We don't care about your employment rates when we got short corners. I'm not sure we've seen one being converted yet. And that's all right, because it's 3-0. And honestly, the Kings crowd are quiet. They've lost interest. They've really, really lost interest. And it's just sad to see.
We're ready now. Hoping for effective one running once again. UCL taking their time to set up. Well, I suppose they have got quite a bit of a cushion of goals. They don't need to rush things by any means. Giving our men a chance to rest. Mr. Kim, he's an old man. I'm sure he's finding it very, very valuable this time of rest.
God,
very
it's,
poor
it's
trap for Castle number 10.
It's another missed trap from Oliver Gatsby. I think Cav really needs to work on his injections, because that Varsity has been lacking. And here we go, the danger man, number 13.
Now's
driving
the time.
The ball. He's got to take it around a few, but one too many. And there's
the
a
arm
stop.
Got extended and down went Dan Volga.
They've stopped time there, but not sure about that. It looked like, to be honest, number 13, the Judas. KCL, we will take him at UCL.
This was always to be expected from Varsity. It's an incredibly competitive game, and emotions are really very fueled here tonight.
And that's number 10, Oliver Gatsby, coming off for the rest of the half with a yellow card there. Haley from Cambridge. Yeah, last year I called his gap year a certain word, let's say fricking boring. And I had to apologise about that, but there's nothing freaking boring about that foul, and I love it, because that's all passion. And as we see the KCL attack fizzle out in the D, it's only a matter of time before the umpires blow for half-time.
This is what happens with the UCL number 10 when you prey on freshers more than you do play hockey.
Patrick,
you get yellow cards.
Patrick, tell me what the KCL half-time is going to be, the team talk is going to be like, because it's 3-0, and honestly, there doesn't seem to be much on.
Well, I'm afraid what it's not going to be is keep playing this same game. It's not going to work very well, I have to be honest about that. But I don't really want to speculate anymore. I don't want to give away too much, perhaps, to a live stream audience, because we may just be ready for a conversion from a short corner, finally.
Of course, it's a King's short corner. Let's hope, just for the sake of the game, the beautiful game that is hockey, that Kings are able to do something here to make things interesting, because I'm bored. I'm falling asleep. Matthew Putt here. He's got his nightcap out and he's had a chamomile tea. He's so sleepy. God, I have to wake him up.
Now, a lot of Kings men are forward here.
Oh, there we go.
A lot is relating to this short corner here today.
And here's the injection. Here we go. The tension's building. And it's a solid injection. Better than Cav has managed. And it's a drag flick, but nothing changing. And a wild swing and a miss for the Kings man up top. And it sort of fizzles out, much like Nick Gill's passing. But here we go.
Here we are.
A UCL counter-attack. It's driving. It's orange juice. It's Sahir Patel, number 9. And he takes it round 1. He's dribbling around the D now. Here we go. It's interesting around the D. I can't tell what that was. A wild swing. Here we go.
Swing after swing after swing, and yet no conversion.
We've got the replay here, and we've got to say, it's some wild swings from UCL. Number 3, Ed Parker, our free transfer from Nottingham University after being dropped by Nottingham Fives. He's found a place at UCL, and honestly, he's not great at hockey. He's like a 16-wheeler, the way he turns. 3-point turns only. Look at him on the ball now. He's confused. We got a nice close-up as the umpire sort of does something. Not sure. I'm not sure what he just said there, but I think he might tell someone off.
I think he was telling your man getting yellow carded to sit on the appropriate chair.
Sit in the appropriate chair.
Mate, can't even follow the rules. Typical.
You know, and UCL, we question authority because we're not afraid to do that. We welcome debate. Unlike KCL, they stifle debate. And no doubt they've got some interesting policies on... God, Matthew Punt, what did you say to me? Matthew
Punt, good work.
On Matthew how to play hockey, because Matthew KCL are truly struggling here, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, mate, I'm afraid that kind of fell off. Good chat from UC.
Free speech was what I wanted to say.
Again, I hate to bring up the eugenics. I hate to bring up the eugenics, but that was a thing that you lot did.
I'd like to refer the Kings fans to the eugenics report that was recently published by UCL. And of course, UCL's claimed full responsibility for that. And you know, any further details can be, of course, referred to at the UCL website. But you know, the prerequisite is that you can read, which of course many Kings players and Kings fans cannot. So it will be difficult, but I'm sure there are sort of, you know, audio versions of that they can refer to as Kings somehow, you know, get into the D there, but it's honestly nothing. And Ed Peachy, the sieve, as he's nicknamed, keeping things interesting.
And that is a dangerous position to lose the ball in for UCL. KCL must be wondering, will this be the last attack of the half?
Dangerous in the same way it's dangerous to eat with a sharp knife, because there is a knife. But it's number 41, matching his age, Amar Khan, running down the wing, the former coach, and there's been a blow as UCL attack, and I'm not sure about that, but we will take that. Half-time.
It is half-time. We have, in fact, a special segment for everybody, I believe.
UCL 3, KCL 0.
If UCL can get involved, I'll announce it on the tannoy. Now is the time.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's UCL 3, KCL 0 at half-time. All you fans...
Yeah, we can do a lot of chatting, we can talk about that game, we can insult UCL because they deserve it.
They're gonna cut it to some video.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
We are UCL men's hockey.
Okay, can you do it again with sound a bit more like excited?
We are UCL men's hockey.
What's your earliest memory of hockey?
So my first memory would have to be when I was 8 or 9 years old, and one day I just picked up a hockey stick, and I immediately fell in love with the game.
My first memory of playing hockey wasn't as nice. I had no idea what was going on, and I kept on getting hit by the ball. 2 years later, I went on tour to Holland, got better at hockey, and that's where I fell in love with the game.
My first memory would have to be my first stick shattering in my hands when I hit the ball and then getting splinters in my hands.
What's the best memory you've had?
Best memory would have to be last year's Varsity match. The results kind of reflected the effort that we put in beforehand. And we came out with a fantastic win, and it was a great time to celebrate with the boys.
My favourite hockey memory at UCL, it has to be my first year Varsity. And then we played the full game, we won 3-0, and it was an amazing after party.
My best memory would have to be the last match we played against AC, which was kind of twice the side of the and then we managed to win.
Okay, I don't understand. So I'd say that one really good thing about the whole UCL hockey environment is that it's provided me with a great group of friends. Wednesday evenings, we all get together and have a good chat after the game.
We say our Wednesday is basically the weekend of the week. It's a great break from all the uni stress that I have.
All of that's true, but I think crucially being part of Varsity gets you some nice kit. Oh, nice little moustache.
So what have you done to prepare for Varsity?
We do weekly training sessions every Monday. All the running that we've done and all the structured training that we've done should go a long way to help us prepare for this match.
On our Monday trainings, we have a new coach, and he often talks about more than just the basics of hockey, what formation we should play and how we should react in games. That's really crucial, especially in a Varsity game where pressure is really high.
Basically just lots of hockey with that. Probably get a warm up or two before the game. The best thing about being captain is probably just leading my mates and my coach and telling people what to do. We'll just go out as a team, eat as we lose, and have a good time.
McIntosh, former UCL men's hockey player. And so, Carl, what are your opinions of the game so far?
Oh, I think it's been a great game, but honestly, pretty dominant from one side. There could only clearly be one victor here.
And Carl, clear that up for the Kings fans, because they might not understand who is the dominant side.
Sorry, are there Kings fans?
Strand Polytechnic.
Oh, those!
I know.
I thought they were just, you know, people of myth and legend that
really existed below. Really basic chat from the booth here, but we don't mind it.
Right. So UCL are going to be having a really enjoyable half-time time here. They've been playing excellently. And any errors made have been made in the KCL half, where you want to be making such errors.
You know, it's Coach Asif with the team talk here at half-time, and word of the street, Winston Churchill got his famous speech from Asif himself. You know, it's 3-0 for UC, but we're down in Varsity Series, so Asif is going to really hope that this is when we turn it back now. And Patrick's back in the booth after no doubt having his Strongbow Dark Fruits as a little refresher.
Oh, am I budget Patrick?
Apparently so, Carl.
Oh, I'm sorry, Patrick.
Here are the Kings boys walking out now, and to be fair to them, they're walking out with their heads held high. Despite being 3-0 down, they're coming out to give it a good shot.
Well, one consolation for Kings is that, you know, there's jobs as bin men available, no training required, you just pick it up as you go along.
There's a tango here.
That's naughty.
As we're about to kick off the second half here, what is the plan? What was the talk in the huddle for the Kings men, Patrick?
I imagine it went something along the lines of, why does their kit look like it was made by children in Vietnam? And I imagine that was most of the discussion. Not a whole lot of strategy, so I'm kind of covering all their bases.
And I'll have to refer all questions about that to none other than Andy Z, our kit sec. You know, I can't say I agree with the sleeveless shirts, but why not? Why not? A little bit of innovation, a little bit of exploration. We don't stifle that kind of thing at UCL. Unlike Kings game with the stock standard plain red kit, as they lose the ball on their left-hand side of the pitch.
We are proud of our kit, proud to be wearing red, a true colour. It's a prime colour, in fact. We don't have to mix anything just to get purple.
Kings don't like mixing because they just support straight prime colours and lack of diversity, as we all know.
Well, I think our wealth being a diversity set would have a lot to say about that.
And in the small break I had for halftime, I just was left with one question, Patrick. Where is Louis? I miss Louis, my co-commentator from last year.
No doubt
he's watching at home or if he's in the stands.
He moved on. He retired. He graduated. Louis moved on, unfortunately. Hate to break your heart like that.
Just like Kings, the commentators from the hockey club, they're decaying with age. And it's just sad to see because, honestly, there's no point anymore. Last year, the women's club played Imperial, and seeing the men's club might have to follow suit because it's just not competitive.
This is a strong push from Kings.
Sort of fizzes out to nothing.
Almost nothing. Oh, you see, get the ball anyway. Actually, I was thinking about this all the while. Have you not decided whether you're a university or a college yet?
The clue's in the name, buddy. It's university first, college second.
Because, you know, there's this TV show out in the United States, very well for children. They have college university. The joke being that it's a stupid name. Get a better name, chaps.
Oh,
Dan Folger now on the ball, looking for the penetrate the D. He's got his money marlings now.
Oh, that's Ed Peachy with the save there. And it's beautiful. He really snuffs out the danger. There's a replay here.
Unfortunately, not a time for Peachy's philanthropy.
Oh, it's a nightmare. It's a nightmare on the cam. But that's all right. But all you need to know, the highlights is Ed Peachy, nicknamed the Sieve. God, he may as well be nicknamed the Bucket because nothing's coming through that. And there is, Polly, no hole in that bucket.
Dan Volgan looking again for a deep penetration.
Another solid tackle. It's number 5, Luke Cargan. All the way from Arding Lye on the ball there. Moved on to number 10, Oliver Gadsby. Now on the right flank. And we're all the way back to the sleeves, green sleeves, Matthew Cavalier. And there he is. Oh, God, that was awful.
Fresh rate and working his magic. Move on to Sexy Big Slaps. Move it back to Fresher Aiden.
I have to say, Kings are up for it. And, you know, you got to praise be to God, because if not, it would have been a boring game. Matthew Punt's already asleep.
Alex Tan makes the move and he's ejecting.
Now, KCL have started this half with some real intensity. Something UCL perhaps have something to learn by. But nothing can be said other than to exaggerate and to just emphasise quite how intensely clinical UCL's defence has been today.
It has been quite a spectacle, I must admit. I'm obviously not being nice. It's not all about the chat here. It's also about the hockey. It has been a real high quality defence. We've got a really, really strong set of forwards, and not a whole lot has been able to get through.
I have to reiterate, this is a UCL team game for the treble here. They've won the league, they've won the cup, and they're going for the Varsity. And, you know, to be honest, it looks likely for them. They're going to complete the treble under the leadership of Luke Cargan, number 5 there. It looks like there's nothing in their way apart from number 13.
Alex Tan now picks up the ball, calmly moves it back to Mr. Kim. Property portfolio and business flowing through his veins. KCLHC, his very essence. It's in his third year now at his undergrad, age 37. I don't think he's attended a single class. He's just here for the hockey.
Third year and he's still not one of us, as he just slaps it out for a UC sideline. I want to see UC get creative here.
I thought you were already very creative and dynamic. Has it not been creative and dynamic? I haven't thought so.
That's a brilliant example of playing to the whistle by UCL.
Oh, and he's down on the ground. So here, he is made of glass. He's upset about that.
That's an excellent take.
It's disgusting from Kings. He's limping around the pitch to hear Patel, number 9, made of glass. I don't think he stretched about 5 hamstrings this season. I thought he only had 2, but he's insisted that you have 8, a future standard chart.
Mate, with legs
signing
that long, he's got at least 20 hamstrings in there. He must do.
An example of KCO anatomy. Of course, the joke is you only have 2. They couldn't quite understand it, as UCL in the D again. Not quite sure what's happening, but it's sort of resolved itself to a KCL ball-ish. Never mind.
Hard fight from Josh Sturby now, back to the 16 for Kings. He's got a proper setup now, chaps.
And now all UCL need to do is to calm down. They've got a 3-0 cushion here. Now they can relax, lean back on their 2 wonderful centre-backs, and have an enjoyable Varsity.
Look, I think the last thing's missing from this game is a few cards. I want to see a red. I just want to see a red. I want to see a sort of neck-high stick tackle from a player, because that would just make my day. So whoever it is, my money's on Luke Cargill, number 5. I just want to see a red. Because why
not? Who's your target, Andrew? Who's your target?
It's got to be number 13, Judas. He betrayed the big man himself, number 13. He's got to be wearing that number for a reason. So none other than Luke Kang on the ball now. It's got to be him. It's Amar Khan, number 41, down the left. Played for Manchester University Hockey. He's a proper journeyman. He's played for about 7 different clubs across the country, and he's found himself at UC at the ripe old age of 41, of course, managing his shirt number and his attack sort of...
Must be past his bedtime, though. I mean,
he's got to be struggling. His wife and 4 kids will be very happy that he's made it onto the pitch today. Of course, last year he was coaching over that famous victory, that COVID victory, 6-1.
His pull-out game's about as weak as UCL chat.
Got no comment about that, of course, because such immature japes have no place in the commentary box. As UCL enter the D,
don't try and high road this. Don't try and high road this. There's nothing moral about what we're doing.
Some meager chants from the KCL crowd there. They seem to have lost interest. There's not much going on.
The
signs are down. There's not much hope there. Whilst the UCL crowds prepare for their victory, they're burning some Bertie.
Brought out the megaphone, compensating for the lack of UC crowd.
Here we can see
the power
UCL
of our voices.
UCL allowing King some space.
Very gracious of you, thank you.
Oh, a missed trap around the back from KCL. Of course, UCL not quite able to pounce on it.
UC now pick up the ball. They're still fighting hard. It's very scrappy out here in the midfield. Looked like a back stick, but the umpire's not going to call it.
And it's number 7 the ball, a man we haven't quite talked about, Rahul. He's moved it on to number 9. So here, Patel, that danger man, into the D now. And he's going to take that long corner. Diplomatic hockey from the man himself, the diplomat, the welfare sec for this year. He's done a great job.
No, is he the one writing all of the player profiles?
No.
Didn't think so. I was hoping he'd have better chat than some of them. And Dan Fogel's off. He's driving hard in the
space. Slice him up, Elliot. Slice him up. That's number 13. Don't let him play. Slice him up. And there's nothing on there. A wild slash the ball. It's going to have to use it as sideline. And he's on the floor now. Cramp, I think.
But he's just taking every opportunity to stretch. He's just that much of an athlete.
And that just goes to show that UCL cannot take their finger off the pulse. Kings are still a force to be reckoned with.
To be honest, I have to disagree with that. There was nothing there but a wild swing of the swing and a miss. And it almost hit the M25. How high it was going.
That's an excellent touch.
UCL firmly in possession, looking for that deep penetration, halted by Tom Grout.
And we take that short corner. Come on, I want to see one more. I want to see a short. As if on the sideline, he's clapping with his signature blue coat, black tracksuit, and yellow bobble hat. Right, I want to see if we'll see a change. We've had several balls to the first castle to be trapped by to number 10, Oliver Gadsby, all over Cambridge. But we have number, I believe, 16, Clemore, stepping up for the injection this time. So that indicates a little change of pace. And let's see what the boys in purple have to open the scoring for the second half.
It has indeed been a goalless second half so far. UCL piling on enough pressure. Maybe possibly too late.
That's
I'm hoping we can pile on enough pressure that we can make this game even more interesting.
Oh, and
very poor from the short corner.
Get that man, number 10, off the pitch, honestly.
Yeah, Mal, just give him another yellow for that.
I've got to say, there's got to be a change up there, because we've had 3 or 4 short corners now and none of them have quite landed. But once again, Kings player a sort of speculative long ball into the D and nothing's come of it.
Like, sexy big slaps, always
and
looking
for
those big
slaps. Here we go, number 8, Matthew Whiting. Look sexy, play sexy on the ball now, and it's into the D. Ah, nothing comes of it. Oh, never mind. Oh, my God. You know, I shut off there. The entire commentary box shut off there. But here we go. Let's see on the replay what happened there. It's just number 6 on the ball. A little, you know, put it far post. Place it where the keeper isn't. And it's opened the scoring for the second half. And to be honest, it's really shut the game off. Number 6, credit to... It's not on my list of players. I have no idea who number... Oh, Miles. Miles, fresh Miles from Cardiff University.
Andrew, we can see now that UCL, they're comfortable, they're having fun out there. They're trying different things.
And the Burlington Berties come out from UCL. At least I go to UC, as they say. Because honestly, at least I go to UC and not to the...
Oh, the Strand Poly, is that where you're going to be your next line?
I wasn't.
Very imaginative, Andrew.
I wasn't, but Patrick, you know, you can fill in the blanks for yourself. I was going to leave that to you. You see a bit,
I've just read your
a bit
book.
Touchy about
I've
the fact your about book. Your polytechnic status.
You just need to get better chat, my friends. Get new material. Parry,
I'll
have a word
happily give up
for
chat for hockey ability, because it seems you still have that and Kings have none. Avenging our women's club and, of course, the Rums yesterday.
Number 1 is storming down the pitch. And which way is that going to go? A UCL 16.
Harrison seems to not agree, appealing to both umpires for it to go the correct way. Apparently not, the call's been given anyway. Never mind the umpires rescinding on their decision.
I don't like that. I want an umpire who's he's confident in the decision making, because you know the Kings players didn't even think it was a long corner themselves.
Well, number 1 did, and he's back on the ball. A Kings ball again in a threatening position.
We're just piling the bodies forwards, looking for any opportunity now to see if we can get something on goal. They'll be injected in. Look at that penetration. UC defense pick it up though. It's still being fought for.
What I want to see from UCL now is a clean sheet, because you know Ed Peach, he's been leaky all season. He's been leaky all season. I can't comment about the status of his batter, but you know the weather street he has been leaky, and I couldn't quite work out whether it was talking about his urination habits or his goalkeeping abilities. The ones, of course, have had 3 different keepers this season. Gave him Charlie Timms and Tom Hall, but they've settled on Ed Peachy, the future kit secretary of the club. And here we go again on the Kings of Time. Maybe he will be tested, but of course, that man, number 6, Miles, snuffs out again after scoring the goal. He's doing his defensive duties and is around the back now. Sleeves again. It's a questionable choice. Number 4 from UCL.
And off it comes. Ball firmly under control, apparently, by UCL. That's the extent of that man's ability.
Toby Middleton now coming on.
He's receiving instructions from Coach Asif. But once again, I've got to reiterate, I'm not happy about that sleeve choice from Cav. I don't know what it was.
Poor.
We're in agreement there, Patrick.
Yeah.
I wanna know whether that was a direct memo from Team GB. Maybe they didn't quite get the moment to look sexy, play sexy, because Cav, I know, is packing some biceps. I'm not sure why he's covering them up for us, but maybe less
all
is more.
All the bicep work from
less
excessive masturbation, I imagine.
Run through the middle of the pitch, and nothing comes. Oh, I like that. I like that call a lot, umpires. They've given us a UC. And Patrick, the only question left remaining is, how did you spend your St. Patrick's Day on Thursday?
By chopping as much Guinness as I could possibly get down, mate.
Chopping Guinness.
Wait, it's St. Mead Day. It's the closest thing I get to a birthday.
On a weekday. The closest thing you get to the birthday surely is your actual birthday.
Nah, it's middle of exams, unfortunately. It's really dead. It's so dead.
Typical. Married to the library at GKT. GKT? God, fuck.
How dare you? How dare you?
I really forgot that.
I wish there is one GKT thing only arguably worse than UCL, and that is GKT.
Of course, we love our Rams collies, as it's a short corner for UCL. Again, and let's see what they've got in store, because, you know, if it was me on the sidelines, Coach Asif, I wouldn't be, as he checks his watch, we're into Fergie time here. I wouldn't be letting Oliver Gadsby anywhere near the stops. But of course, he's collected much experience on his gap here. And, you know, it's been a great social set this year. Fantastic social set. I just want to see him thrive. And it upsets me when I see him mistrap every injection. So it's sleeves once again on the short corner. Number four, Matthew Cavalli with the injection. Let's see if he goes to the slap. There's a different look this time. It's not Oliver Gadsby on the castle, but Elliot is lining up. Let's see where they go. Here we go. It's out now, and that's it's a decent trap from Ed Peachy, and it's a slap.
Saved by Antonio. Fantastic work there. He's still calm. He's still got it.
Do you see the CB replay now? He's gone for a slap instead of a drag flick, and it's a decent save from the keeper. I'll give Kings that. You know, he's not made many saves today.
Fantastic trap again by the number 15. That's very consistent performance there.
And to those watching on our stream, you couldn't see that, but on the sidelines, our coach asked, he's showboating now. He's throwing his gloves around. He's having a bit of fun with the crowd because it's 4-0 UCL, and there's nothing on. And I just want to see them improve on the 6-1 score from last year. And a one more goal made me truly happy.
It is strong from Peachy not to continue his philanthropy that is apparently irregular for him.
Oh, a loose ball around the back from UCL. And it's Luke Cargan on the ball now. The captain's going to want a goal. And here he is. And he bosses it. But it doesn't matter. Because someone scored a goal. Here's the go with the replay. It's Luke Cargan on the ball all the way through. Takes a rebound. And who is that?
What is the
number six, Miles, again on the score sheet.
Long corner.
I don't think it's a goal, though. God.
Long corner, it seems. I believe it came off a goalkeeper from what I saw.
Liu Kong, he's going to be hungry for his goal. As the captain of the team. Here we go, moving it around now. Around the back, it sleeves once again to Ed Parker. Into the D. And there we go, it's another goal for UCL. And it's beautiful. We had a textbook move. Into the P spot there. It's a reverse here. It's beautiful. I can't quite see the number, but he sort of celebrated while I was lying on the floor there.
As I imagine, this night is going to be hashtag bleed purple. I think that we've accepted our fate. I want to call you out on this one. What is the deal with this hashtag? I'm concerned for your health if you're all bleeding purple. Or is it just doping on a scale even the Russians wouldn't consider?
Hashtag bleed purple is sort of... It's a bit of, you know, a little bit of fun. We're having a bit of fun. I know. Kings don't understand that, but we don't have to take everything literally. Purple is the colour of UCL, and we do bleed purple because we care about the club.
It just seems like very poor anatomy.
UCL Medical School is the number one ranked school in the world, medical school. So I have no further comment about that. I understand the GKT managed to win their games yesterday, but I will have no such slight on UCL.
We don't care about GKT.
They don't care about GKT, but we care about Rams. Our Rams cousins, we love you, and we support you.
This win, incestuous
this win is for
there.
You. This win is for you tonight. We got Charlie Pace in the booth.
Dan Folger getting his ankles taken out once again. He's spending a lot of time on the floor thanks to UCL's shenanigans.
It's the rival when it's 41. He's just dribbled through the entire team. And he wants it. And he's in the D and he takes a shot. And he's in. That is a banger. A screamer from number 41. Amir Khan. He doesn't care. He does not care about the Kings players. Because he's just scored an absolute banger on the night. And it's 6-0 UCL. And who cares?
It looks like we're seeing a collapse almost as bad as the collapse last of Varsity. Kings really need to think about what they're doing here. Again, they've given away the ball. It's going up along the right wing. Into the D. Peace pop.
UCL running
up.
Swing.
Save, but still in the D.
And you can tell the UCL men are really up for it. They all want to be on the score sheet tonight. And there's only You know, I've asked many questions today of Patrick and the Kingsmen, but there is one question that's on my mind. Is can you hear the Kingston? Because I can't hear a bloody thing.
We got a lot of support out for Antonio, though. He was put under a lot of pressure and he stayed strong.
They've stayed strong and it's 6-0.
It's back. UCL ball. UCL coming to the D. It's come wide.
Josh Lobby now picking it up in the midfield. Looking for Money Marnix.
Toby Middleton controlling it there. I don't like it. I'd rather he be sent off. I'd rather he didn't make the Varsity score, but he's there. And he's performing, and all I want to see.
Do you know
is
what? I back that chat,
Patrick. You know, if you wanna make a bet tonight, bookmaker's favourite for a red card is Toby Middleton to slice someone open in the middle of the park.
It's UCL ball.
Dan Folger fighting hard in the midfield for the ball.
Oh my God, Toby Middleton, that's disgusting. Sent him off as the coach has to complain to the umpire. He's gonna get sent off. Number 30 still.
See, look at Dan's knee. They're bleeding red like a normal human being.
He's still on the bench as the UCL winner shot. Asif is not happy about that. He's screaming at the umpire there.
KCL are really reaching for anything that's going. They're looking pretty desperate. It's sad to see such a prestigious uni really go to the gutter.
And on the camera right now, you can see Cav receiving some instructions from Asif for the short corner. No doubt telling them to get Gatsby off the shorts because it's not working out, and I want to see some innovation. Cav steps up for the injection.
The shorts looking pretty dangerous. Is there going to be another pointless shoot?
Right, number 10, Oliver Gatsby, maybe at sixth time lucky.
Patrick, what do you think?
Oh, I'm not too sure. I mean, the short corners from UCL
He's
have
not
been
very
amazing.
Confident. This looks like it might be another UC point on the board.
Only if they can trap this ball, which they haven't been very reliable at so far.
And it's in, and it's just a good stop. And we don't mind. That's a foot there, surely. Come on, umpire. There we go.
It's another UC short. Patrick, what are you thinking again?
I'm not rating the chances of the trap. I mean, it's got better over time, but I bloody hope so. They've been playing this game long enough. They should know how to trap a ball by now.
Yeah, it looks like another UC point of the ball, potentially. We'll see how it goes. Obviously, all of the boys want to point on the board. They want their name down on the sheet.
Tom now Sleeve steps up for the injection. Pops in, saved by Antonio. Good reach on there.
It's tight. It goes in. UCF got another thing.
I believe that Sleeves with the goal. We've been calling him Sleeves all day, but why not give him his actual name? It's Matthew Cavalier. Great Britain's most promising prospect since 1843. With 18 England caps to his name and 17 more for Great Britain, is Matthew Cavalier the star player and the leading prospect of English hockey with the goal there. And the Burlington Varsity start as it. It's 7-0 for UCL, and it's a shutout tonight as orange shoes versus orange shoes around the sideline. And as they get close to me, I realise they're pink shoes. But never mind that, because Cavalier, green sleeves, he's at the front now. He normally plays around the back, but he wants it, and that's the important thing.
Matisse showing off his skills now that he's worked hard for in club hockey. Alex Dan now stepping up for the free hit. Who can he find?
Are they going to make anything of this, or can they keep possession?
That is the real test.
That's a poor trap.
Money Marnix picking it up now. Why he was called Money, we still don't know. It was something of Dan Folger's creation.
It comes out for you, see, they're going up the right wing. It looks promising. Is this going to be another point in the shoot?
It's a promising drive around
Ethan
the right wing.
Ethan Kim, the wall. Picks it up out the back. Tries to look for Ryan Light, who's just about unable to trap the ball.
It comes nothing. It was 10 minutes around the back. And
Money Marnix now.
Around the back, different step. And, you know, as the boys in purple on the verge of the treble, only, you know, we have to question. We have to open the debate. Silas Ferguson, Pep Guardiola, or Asif for the best managers of the 21st.
Kings clear it.
20 plus one century.
Had to just figure it out there for a second, didn't you?
I will be chinning my water for that discrepancy there. Disgusting stuff. I'm ashamed of myself.
UCL don't have a very proud history department. They don't teach their people very well.
It's a long corner. Taken. Down the right. Comes back around the back foot.
Sleeves with the back. Here we go. Matthew Cavalli all the way to Taylor Mills. Let's see what he wants to do. Down the left.
He's looking very strong.
Oh, into, and he's the into D. The D now, and he leaves the ball.
Comes back,
you know,
out.
We can't expect much more from him because you know, that's his limit.
Ryan Lyde, described by a certain member of our women's committee as alarmingly attractive, putting up a really strong defence there. I'd hasten to agree that flowing hair really does something for me.
Kings are taking their time. They don't want to lose another point.
Money Marnix now looking for that ball. Club Cess extraordinaire couldn't get on the end of that ball.
You see it getting back into the D.
It's green, it's orange shears once again as he gets it across, but they're on the floor, we're scrambling, we still want it. And oh, surely, but surely not at the same time. Kings survive one more time, but you know, as the umpires put their hands to their ears, it's coming to full time now as they check their watch. And you know, I've got to take this opportunity out to shout out the UC crowd, who are looking strong, looking lively. Whereas the KC crowd, you know, they've probably tried their best, but really, I count about four. Charlie, consult with me. There's about four in the KC crowd.
KC crowd's not looking that strong. I'm looking across. It looks like the UC.
It's a tough loss to bear.
Ed Pucci looks like he wants to sit down for a picnic, quite frankly. He's a little bit tired of not getting much action. UC are back into the D, back into the KC, comes back out, drive him back in on the right.
Sleeves once again working his magic. And it's a short. We'll take that. One more short. One more chance to make it 8-0.
It looks like training grounds, quite frankly, at this point. Short corner practice for UC.
Glad to hear that your chat has developed since last year.
Maybe they're going to shake something up. At this point, they might as well practice for next year.
Here we go. Sleeves once again with the injection. They got it all right on the last time round. I believe that's number 10, Oliver Gasby, with number 8, Matthew White. On the ball. Looks sexy, plays sexy. Certainly looks sexy. Will he play sexy with this flick?
Now, this is his first time at the top of the castle this game.
You gotta
hope clearly
he's gonna
hungry go. For more goals.
You gotta hope he's going for a straight flick, but orange shoes, Sahir Patel, he's hungry. Oh, and it's
another missed trap.
Not gonna be happy with that, but he doesn't mind because that's a stick tackle in the middle of the day. It's unbelievable stuff.
Called as a 16.
That's a 16.
Few substitutions.
Thomas York now looking like he's getting warmed up on the sideline, ready for his few minutes of glory in Varsity for the second year running. How wonderful, diversity and well-being set. Josh Lovey now carrying the ball, moves it on. Harrison Slade looking for that ball, but intercepted by UC number 2 man.
Easily intercepted by UC, round the back, comes around, easily filtered out. It's sad to hear Kings not really being supported by a good supporting crowd, but
I've got to say I'm embarrassed for Kings a bit here to be shut out by UCL on the night. It's not going to be the result they want. Number 77 tumbles to the ground. It's just a poor show, to be honest. I thought they would give us something, you know. It's a big night for Varsity. I thought they might give us something, you know. Last year they managed to grab a goal, but this time nothing on. They played regressive hockey. They tried to diplomatic stuff, but you know, Ed Pucci, even the sieve didn't let one through tonight. And it's orange shoes versus orange shoes on the left hand side again.
Looks like a KCR last hurrah, looking for a small crown to rescue what might have been a possible redemption, but alas.
And I think, you know, on behalf of all those watching, we've got to dedicate to the ladies and all those people who've been watching, you know, supporting the team tonight, because as Sahir Patel, orange shoes, runs down the left-hand side of the pitch one more time. He both selfish. Real selfish. Selfish. Not a team player.
He's hungry, though.
Despite his multiple internships, not a team player.
I think UC might be better getting a rota at this point. Just getting a rota to get through the people getting on the score sheet.
Tom Grout throwing the aerial.
Ed Pucci's getting a bit of action. he's quite grateful of that.
Yeah, I think as we enter the closing stage of the match, I do think we've got to say thank you for Kings for turning up tonight. Unlike the Kings ladies last year, they didn't turn up. We've got to say thank you to them because it's the least we can say to give us a good time. We've obviously battered them 7-0 and it could be 8. But we've got to dedicate this team. I know we haven't quite turned this into the Perm Fortress we would hope for with the Rums losses and the ladies losses. But this men's victory, this 8-0 men's victory is really going to probably bring us up on aggregate.
The overall hockey victories for Kings, representative of the whole Varsity series this year. Currently Kings ahead by just a few of the scores. Monty Marnix now finds Jay on the top of the D. He's driving that baseline, defending well against UC.
And there's nothing on us, that man.
Miles Constant-Aaron's looking pretty confident. A lot of space goes to Captain. Captain, again, looking pretty confident. There's a lot of space. KCL really trying anything at this point. Back of the KCL back line.
Gotta say, you know, if we look at the scores in aggregate over the course of the four fixtures we've had, the ladies' runs, they drew, they lost on fixed 3-1, minus 2 for UCL. The men's lost 2-0 for Rums, minus 2 UCL. UCL has to do all the time, it's another goal! And it's 8-0 for UCL. The ladies lost by 1 as we see another replay. But the men's here have won 8-0. It's a simple finish. It's a simple finish for UCL. You know, it's minus 2, minus 2, minus 1 equals minus 5. But it's plus 8 for UCL, which brings us to plus 3 overall. And as is true to the form, Lee Valley LB for London. And London is purple tonight. It's a UCL victory overall. Slice him up. Take him out of the game. Number 30's got nothing on. Oh my God.
Yes, from Justin Elby.
Look,
he manages to score some redemption and his penultimate, maybe even last game for us as a master's student. He graduates this year with honours. Fantastic from Justin Elby. He's able to get something. Thank you very much to Peachy for extending his philanthropy to us. But it was cracking from Derby
the
there.
The Civ lives up to his name, and I wouldn't want anything else because, quite frankly, the Civ lives up to his name there. And you know what? Why not? Why not?
But UCL are coming back, and they're hungry
they're
for
hungry.
More.
He's bottled it.
But you've got to give credit where credit's due. It was an amazing goal by Kings.
Shock
but it is becoming a rout here as UCL are really going for the ninth.
It's nice that KCL can at least give something to their small crowd that turns up tonight.
UCL give it up for number one, Ed Peachy the Civ.
Dan Folger now reclaiming the ball. Looks like aerial for Harrison Slade. Putting Peachy under even
he's
more
trying
pressure.
Again. The Civ strikes again. Surely.
And
no.
Surely the P flip there. I've never seen a more deliberate clearance off the baseline.
The helmet's on the floor. I don't know what's happened, but.
Mate, offensive strategy there from Peachy. If he can get his helmet out to the ball before the rest of him, saves.
And Peachy may be generous, but his generosity has to. Run out sooner or later.
I'm not sure how the helmet ended on the floor, but you know what? He's really living up to his mantle here, and he's got one more year of varsity, so why not? He was one last year, maybe two this year. Oh, and that's full time. And as of course, London is purple. Who could expect anything else as the Kings men go up one more time? You know what? I want a Kings goal. I want to see the Civ strike one more time. You know, why not a purple end goal? Let's see what happens. Patrick, get on the pitch yourself. Score a goal.
I might get in. The impromptu kicking back. Receive the ball. Dribble it around all their players.
I think we quite want to see what the best that the KCL short corner can offer. There are a lot of boys on the D. All lined up.
Ready? This is going to get scrappy, chaps.
Patrick, what do you think it's going to be? Going in.
Goal from Dan Folger.
The Civ redemption. The Civ strikes again. Why bloody not? 8-2 UCL. Why not? We take that. 6
6 goal difference, better than last year's 6-1. We take it and it's a UCL victory in London is purple. Thank you very much. That's
congratulations,
all.
Congratulations, unfortunately, to UCL. Goal scored by Dan Fogelberg and Bowen Vale. 7-2 final score. London is indeed purple.
Another great victory for UCL. Patrick, can you remind me, when was the last time that KCL won a hockey varsity?
Oh gosh, before my time. It's been unfortunate. I have a feeling it was about 3 years ago. And the trend continues. I can only wish you lot congratulations. Got to be sportsman about
KCL
it. Well done to you.
KCL has achieved the triple. They have won the cup, their league, varsity. They go on for a very strong season next year. We are very excited to see what happens. KCL are very excited to have the small...
Harrison Slade's keen to get on the Jaeger bombs.
They're looking to drown their sorrows in the vaults later.
Glorious evening defeat, chaps.
Ladies and gentlemen, give up your man of math, Edward Peachy the Sixth!
Whoa!